Now, Northridge Mall began yesterday. The demolition was met with protesters advocating for proper pay as it began to break ground. According to the protester Mike Irvin, a local 139 member, the construction workers and heavy machinery operators were not being paid the proper wages for this project. According to Fox 6 Milwaukee, the demolition is funded using $15 million from the American Rescue Plan Act. The mall was purchased by the city. However, Mayor Johnson Cavalier states there are no certain plans for the property quite yet. The current goal is to have the entire property completely demolished by fall of 2025. Milwaukee police are asking for help to locate a missing 21-year-old woman named Brittany Thurmond. According to the police, Thurmond was last seen yesterday around 10:30 a.m. near Hampton and Sherman. It has also been alleged that she was with a man named Alfred Savoy. Savoy drives a 2021 black Honda Civic with temporary plates U727ZE. Thurman is around 5'6" and weighs 150 pounds with medium-length black hair. If you have any information, call MPD's 7th District at 414-935-7272. Two Milwaukee Department of Public Works employees have pled guilty to federal charges of embezzlement. The employees Kelly Whitmore Bailing and Kyle Kep were accused of embezzling more than $100,000 from the city and later used it to gamble at Pottawatomie Casino. Their roles for the DPW were to maintain a fleet of city-owned vehicles and equipment. In 2022, they were able to accomplish this crime by selling the surplus of the property. According to the prosecutors, they sold the property they oversaw through DPW for less than the market value. The two have agreed to pay restitution to a total amount of $357,000. The DPW has yet to comment on whether they are still employed. This has been your news update. The Tory Lowe Show is next on the new 101.7 The Truth.
We need each other.
That's facts.
I need my sisters. I need my brothers out here.
A coward dies a thousand deaths, and for all the bootlickers, may you die 1,001.
The place for the realest conversations.
Tory Lowe, all the ashes? Or you want all the smoke? Oh, this
nigga, I'm with all that smoke too, man.
I didn't see Ron Johnson. He trash. Chisholm is trash.
How the hell are you here to help us? And your kids are dying in the street.
I understand that this is Milwaukee and everyone believe that if someone say something, it's mentioned. It's not.
I don't care if it's the past. If you see the pastor acting right, you check that fool. Where's the results?
Talking topics that need to be highlighted and discussed in our communities.
Would you trade places with a black person?
No, I would not.
Have you ever said the N-word?
I'm not.
Come on, be the truth. We on the truth.
Unfiltered and unfazed, this is the Tory Lowe Show on 101.7 The Truth and The Truth app.
The reason I believe the racism is getting worse is because whites know that they will be outnumbered in about 20, 21 years. They're going to be outnumbered.
Hey, Tory, man, how are you doing, brother? I'm actually from India. We brown people can totally relate with you. And sometimes it's like, did that just happen to me?
We have to not let the government mind us either.
That cop ain't never been brought to the public because he ain't normal, and he may not even exist no more.
Say no more. Release the video.
You know, you keep on doing what you're doing, man. You're going to take over this talk radio, man. Just keep on focusing on what you're focusing on. I wish you a lot of love.
God bless you, brother.
Now, live from the American Family Insurance Studio in Milwaukee, here is Tory Lowe.
Justice Wisconsin, the truth. The most requested advocate in the state. 101.7 FM. The movement continues. Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Milwaukee, stand up, stand up.
It's Tory Lowe, the truth, from 1 to 4. We about that action, so tap in and let's go. We want that justice, we want all the smoke. From Monday through Friday, trying to bring the city hope. Yeah, Tory Lowe from 1 to 4, Monday through Friday, let's go. We bout that action from the block, and we ready, let's go. Tap in, and it ain't no holding back. We ready, we ready.
101.7 The Truth. Tory Lowe, Tory Lowe Show, live from American Family Insurance Studio at the Avenue, and I'm here for the atch,
and I'm butt that atch,
and I want all the smoke.
Who wants the smoke today?
Salute to my brothers and sisters on the front lines. The marathon continues.
The movement continues.
How you doing, DJ Brother Z?
It's Thursday.
And how y'all doing out there in Radio Land, Truth Nation? Hey, thank you for joining me this Thursday, March 21st, 2024. And we got some guests coming in at 2. We got some guests. Also, I got a question for Truth Nation, but I think that I want to talk about it, you know, since we got guests at 2. I think I want to talk about it right now because usually at 2 o'clock, I ask the question, but I think we should open up the lines for a few people to tap in. And this is just a simple question. It's a simple question. Can, all right, and like I said, y'all, you know, DJ Brother Z, I'm just talking because I'm seeing a lot of this on Instagram, on Facebook, while I'm scrolling. Can a male who's dating a male give females advice on how to keep a man? Can a male who's dating a male, you know, who may be trans woman, right, give women advice on how to keep a man? I'm going to need y'all women to chime in because I'm seeing a lot of this, and I think that a lot of y'all starting to look like men who are dating males, I mean, with the hairstyle. I mean, I'm just asking because I see this. Or can a woman who's a trans male give advice on how to keep a woman? I'm starting to see this as I scroll. And when I was, you know, coming up, you know, you didn't see a lot of this. But a lot of people in the comments are saying, hey, is this reliable advice? I just want to know. 833-212-1017. Talk to text. 833-212-1017. Can it happen? And you know what? When I was down in New Orleans, I used to date a girl from New Orleans. And back when I was, you know, in those days, you know, about, what, 10 years ago or so? Like probably 15 years ago. She would talk about some of those singers and dancers down there that are really popular, like Big Frida. Big Frida, it was a lot of, you know, drag ideas that were extremely popular in New Orleans, and they was doing bounce, you know, the bounce music. And the women would do their dances, so the males who, went into being a female idea, they were doing a lot of the music ideas, and the women were copying them in the way they did their hair, in the way they danced, like with the movement and everything. So years later, in 2024, you see that Beyonce working with Big Frida. You know what? It's a children's YouTube. It's a children's YouTube called Gracie's Corner.
Yeah, Gracie's Corner.
Gracie's Corner that blew up. I mean, it's all the kids know who
adults
Gracie.
Adults too, Tori.
Yeah, yeah, well, adults watch it. Yeah, they learn some. Well, okay,
this is the truth.
I do watch it. I mean, I do understand Gracie's Corner.
She is in my Spotify. Snoop Dogg
definitely is got a character on Gracie's Corner. But then you see the Big Frida ideas. You know, you see that where, you know, these figureheads are starting to lead women groups. And you know, we have the discussion about women's sports, the women's movement, and things like that. But you never see it on the other side, though. You never see the woman who wants to be the male or who feels like they're a man trying to lead the men's group or trying to gain footage on the men's side or play in the men's basketball games and things on the tournament side. So my thing is, my question is, and I really would love to hear from women, can a trans woman who's dating a male give a woman advice on how to keep a man? Because I'm seeing this in my news feed, and I just want to know, can it happen, or do you take the advice, or does it even really matter? I want to take a few calls. 833-212-1017. Somebody said, you lost me today on the slick freestyles. I'm going to come in after your guest, bro. Somebody says, you lost me on the slick lifestyles. I'm just saying. I'm just telling you what I see. I don't care if, I don't care how you feel about it. I'm just telling you it's happening. And so I just wanted to bring that to the conversation. I don't even want to talk about this Miss Netta. It's this person that's out here that's dating Charles. She got a song called Charles, Your Lunch Is Ready, Miss Netta, and they give advice on how to feed a man and things like that. You know, so I'm just interested. I want to know how y'all feel about it, if y'all seeing that. I just want to know. We're going to head to the line. Shirley, you on the new 101.7 The Truth. How you doing, Shirley?
On my way to work, sir. On my way to work.
Shirley, I'm seeing a lot of men, trans women, that's what they're calling themselves, that date men, giving women advice on how to keep a man.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, when I was coming up, that wasn't what we was, you know. Now it's 2024, and it's like, okay, you see this explosion out here of these certain ideologies. Even there's trans males that are dating women trying to give men advice on how to keep a woman. How do you feel about it?
Okay. Tory, I just made 59 years old March 15th.
Mm-hmm.
So you know I'm from the old school.
Right.
I'm from the old school.
From the back in the day.
Back in the day. And I'm proud of it. And I'm very happy that I'm still here.
Mm. Same.
Can a trans person tell me nothing?
Mm.
You hear what I'm saying? They can't give me no kind of advice. They can't give me nothing but stay out of my way.
Mm.
I keep my opinions most of the time to myself.
Right.
I really do, because they have a right to be who they want to be. Now, if they want to give advice, feel free to do so. But it's up to the person who wants to receive them advice. I choose not to receive it. You're not a woman. You never will be a woman. Biologically, you're not. You still don't know what it feels like to be a woman. You just don't. You can't tell me anything. And any woman that follows that type of advice, shame on you. And you don't know who you are as a woman.
Mm.
You really don't.
They need to take tips from the woman.
Yes. If I want some advice, I will contact another woman to do that. No, a trans person can't tell me nothing. And that's no, I'm not being mean, or I'm not, you know. Tell your own people that, your own transients or whatever you want to call it.
Mm.
But no, I will not listen to it. And I don't agree with Big Freedia on Gracie's Corner. I don't like it.
Oh,
and
wow. Did you see what they did with that?
I saw it. I will not let my grandchildren see it. No.
Mm.
I don't agree with their lifestyle.
And so,
I just don't.
When you see things like that, and many times a lot of families who are traditional male and female, they sometimes, some of the programming, especially if it's reaching the masses, it has that in there.
I know it does. But just because you're reaching the masses doesn't mean that your message is right.
Mm.
It doesn't mean your message is right. Because a lot of stuff out here, these young people are listening to, but that doesn't mean that it's right. I mean, they do. Wrong is so right where everything wrong seems to be right now.
Mm.
Everything seems all mixed up.
It seemed like everything got flipped.
Yes.
I'm seeing it. We all watching it, especially if you're from Generation X, or, you know, when you was back, you know, I'm Generation X, so I've seen a lot of things change over time, and now I'm trying to keep my children with my ideology. And like I said, I have no problem with what people believe in or whatever. I never had that issue, but respect the boundaries that I have.
But Corey, the boundaries that we have, they're trying to make it seem like how we feel is wrong.
Mm.
I have a right to feel the way I do, just like you do.
Right.
I'm not infringing on you. Don't infringe on me.
I agree. Hey, I appreciate you for tapping in, Shirley. We got Al on the lines. Al, you're on the new 101.7 The Truth. Tap in.
Well, I respect everybody's opinion.
Right.
But it can't be too bad if your husband is stepping out on you with it.
You said that it's men that's going for it, dealing with the trans woman.
Let's keep it 100, Tory. A lot of these men is seeking these trans women out. And one thing we have to understand, a man knows what another man wants, just like a woman knows what another woman wants. So you might not have to agree with it, but there's a lot of y'all who are doing stuff with your husband because you don't want to lose him, even though you don't like it. So you can respect your opinion, mm-hmm. and they should respect your opinion.
I agree.
But keep in mind, wisdom comes with diversity and growth. And some of those transgender is out there that's probably keeping your man at home, because when he gets done spending that money, he comes back home.
What?
So y'all need to understand that. Because keep this in mind, a lot of those men y'all mess with from prison got a boyfriend in prison.
Mm.
And while he's laying in a bed with you, he was wishing he was with that man in prison. And that man
his real boyfriend behind bars.
Exactly the same with these pimps and pushers. A lot of them out there having sex with men just to get the drugs, and they come right back home to you.
You see a lot of that coming out. A lot of people just coming out saying, hey, this is what it is. You see a lot of people not hiding that fact.
Tory, this stuff been going on since the 50s and 60s. They just keeping it hush-hush. I know women out there that's doing threesomes with their husband, and that woman don't even like women, but she went down on the other one.
It always been there.
Have a good day. Have a good one.
And on that note, we going to run the break. Truth Nation, stay like that right here on Tory Lowe.
And that's Tory Lowe, bringing you all the action and all the smoke. Don't touch that dial. The Tory Lowe Show will be right back on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com. Need a way to hype up your day?
Yes, who am I speaking with?
Sherwood Hughes, you just won $5,000! $5,000, Patricia! You're rich, not really, not intergenerational wealth, but you just won $5,000!
What would you do with $5,000?
Oh, well, I am going to pay some bills. Oh, my God!
Stay tuned into 101.7 The Truth for your chance to be entered into the Gruber Law Office's 5K giveaway. For contest rules, visit 1017thetruth.com.
The Empowerment Small Business Loan Program, we're talking about up to $5 million, which for small business owners, we need that. That's like payroll, that's resources. So can you just let us know, what is the program and why is this lending program so important to Old National Bank?
Years ago, our CEO, Jim Ryan, this program is his brainchild. He was working with Roland Shelton, who you know, Denise, out of Evansville. And they identified that African-American business owners, Hispanic business owners, Native American business owners, as well as women business owners, had a difficult time in obtaining financing from the traditional credit partners. So we went out, created a program, launched it last year, 2023. And so far last year, we have helped over 100 successful minority and women-owned businesses with about $25 million in loans. We have already started this year with almost $8 million in approvals, again, geared toward minority business owners and women business owners that normally had difficulties in obtaining traditional credit finance.
When it comes to getting the smile of your dreams, you can't just trust anyone. So look no further than Bubon Orthodontics. Bubon Orthodontics is Wisconsin's number one Invisalign provider and has been providing the best value for braces and Invisalign since 1993. With 15 convenient locations, you're sure to find one in your area. Schedule your free consultation today. Call or text 262-522-7447 or visit BubonOrtho.com. Bubon Orthodontics, a family treating families.
Be the MVP of gift giving with a Milwaukee Bucks gift card. From exhilarating Bucks experiences to unforgettable Fiserv Forum events, your gift card recipient can score tickets to Bucks games and other events through the Ticketmaster box office. Shop exclusive gear at the Bucks Pro Shop or get a favorite snack at Fiserv Forum's concessions. It's a win-win gift that lets them choose their experience. To purchase a gift card, visit bucks.com/giftcards.
It's the Tory Lowe Show on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Keep the bag, King Walker.
Get some money. 101.7 The Truth, Tory Lowe Show, DJ Brother Z on the ones and twos. Hey, look, don't forget to tune in as we broadcast live on 101.7 The Truth, live on YouTube, The Tory Lowe Show. We going live right now. You can see me looking handsome. And you can join the chat. Tap into the conversation today. I want to head over to Detroit. Over to Michigan, where a woman says she was recently fired from her high school teaching position because she was moonlighting as a rapper. Let's listen.
Until the parent kept continuously complaining.
Most high baby going crazy like the 80s.
Hey. Hey.
Dominique Brunk, whose rap name is Drippin' Honey, has been an educator for 7 years and started teaching history at Taylor Preparatory High School in August. But all that came to an abrupt end months later, after she says a parent came across one of her rap videos.
The first meeting that I had with like the principal and the dean, they had told me that the parent wished to stay anonymous and she felt as if she didn't like my rap career and that I was a bad influence on the kids because I rap.
She says she was fired in February because she's a rapper. Before the firing, around Thanksgiving, she says there were meetings and an ultimatum.
My mind and my heart was telling me two things. I couldn't see myself like giving up my other passion just because somebody didn't like it. And they said erase all your content. That was the ultimatum.
What?
Erase all your content. I'm just like, respectfully, I can't do that.
Brown acknowledges the profanity in her lyrics, but she says that has nothing to do with Taylor Prep and the positive impact she's had on her students and the community.
Is it that they didn't like your rapper career, or was it that they didn't like necessarily the content?
The meetings were so like one-sided to where they only told me what somebody didn't like. They didn't tell me as if you did this wrong.
As she was hot.
Wrong.
So they didn't say the videos
also,
was lit.
On my behalf, I'm like, well, send me what am I doing wrong in writing?
The writing was on the wall. Despite that, in December, she won Teacher of the Month. In February, on her last day, she created a music video with her students that has since gone viral.
As a parent, we long for teachers who support our children and who inspire them. And she was one of those teachers. So really, truly disappointed.
Christina Lynn says her son, an 11th grader, started a petition in support of Ms. Brown, gathering over 200 student signatures. Lynn says she's seen Brown's videos and that they are no different than any other hip-hop video a child can access on social media.
For me, it doesn't matter what you do outside of, the education structure. Like, once you leave that particular building and you go on with your life, then you do whatever you do.
Brown says she misses her students and making an impact.
These kids have their own goals, their own aspirations, so I'm just trying to see how I can help them.
All right, DJ Brother Z. Dominique Brown, she was an educator for 7 years. And they said that she had to make a decision between being a rap artist and a teacher. Now, a lot of people would say the teachers don't get paid enough. And the rappers get paid more than the teachers. You know, so the priorities here. So it was only a matter of time before a teacher would be inspiring to be a rapper to use the teaching job as a part-time idea while she's working on her career. So is this an issue with the pay salary that the teachers get? And should she be fired for having another situation where she's making money?
If she deserves to be fired
for that, then the teachers deserve to be fired for using Sexy Red lyrics in the classroom.
And you know, we played that where the little girls was in there singing the Sexy Red lyrics, talk about hands on your knees. And then people didn't have a problem with it. They said if you can reach the kids, that's all they trying to, they hopefully they can get somebody in there that they can reach the kids. And I had an issue with that because Sexy Red may not be the right tool, even though, you know, what grown parent is letting their kids listen to Sexy Red, knowing that she producing porn rap. So, like I said, but it was only a matter of time before, you know, because teachers, you know, I believe that they should be making extra money, but I think it's I think it's when they talk about being around children every day, you got to be careful. And like I said, I don't knock that idea either, but was it that raunchy though? Was it Sexy Red style, or was she, you know, what kind of style of music was she playing, or was she making? Sound like she was just making like party up music. Play a little snippet again. I want to hear the chorus. Let me hear the chorus on this song. When you get the chorus up, I want to hear it, because it just sounded like she was just making like a celebratory, like let's everybody get together back in the 80s. Back in the day, we used to dance and have parties and have fun. Rap was more fun back then. You know, people was dancing, having fun with rap. Now you got to spin the block. Let's listen to the chorus. Let's see. Let Truth Nation, tap in.
Dominique Brown.
Motown baby going crazy like the 80s. Motown baby going
Dominique Brown.
Okay. Rap name is Motown baby going crazy like the 80s. Okay. It depends on what era she is. She talking about the crack, going crazy like the crack era?
I mean,
because you know they got the BMF story out there right now. The BMF with 50 Cent on Stars right now, so I don't know. But Truth Nation, look, we always got these conversations on who can make the connection with the kids. The kids, they using the rappers to make the connection with the kids. Now we got a teacher who is the rapper, and now she lost her job for moonlighting as a rapper. Also, that you remember that last year was a teacher that blew up on the internet, on social media. She blew up for making, like, you know, friendly, teachable rap style. But then a year later, she was found to be having a relationship with a 15-year-old student. Hey. Hit me on the talk to text. How y'all feel about it, Truth Nation? When we come back, we're going to have a pop culture report. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
More of the Tory Lowe Show is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
It's early in the year and we're trying to hit these fitness goals. Zero to 100 Fitness is dedicated to the Milwaukee community, offering affordable and quality fitness and mixed martial arts programs for the last 10 years. They have competitive and novice classes in MMA, kickboxing, and grappling for all skill levels and ages. From youth, community outreach, women's self-defense, and personal safety programs, Zero to 100 Fitness will help you on your journey to greatness. So get up off the couch and into the best shape of your life. Call 414-522-1275 today.
Wisconsin is as hardworking of a place as you'll ever find. There's a sense of pride, community, and work ethic that's second to none. People here are tough, but even the toughest among us need help after a serious accident. At Gruber Law Offices, we won't stop fighting for you and your family. We've been here and will continue to be here for as long as you need us. Gruber Law Offices, one call, that's all.
It's time for Truth Takes, a thought-provoking commentary on the new 1017 The Truth. Here is Denise Thomas with her truth.
Abundance, prosperity. Those are just two words to describe what I want to experience in this thing called life. I am committed to winning and helping others win. And what I'm realizing as part of that journey of abundance, success, and increase, I'm going to have to get more complete with using the word no. There is power in saying and using the word no. And what's even more incredible about the word is that it's universal. No matter where I am in this world, everyone understands the meaning of no. And the importance of saying no is not about rejecting others. It's not about creating barriers between you and someone else. It's more about making sure that as part of our self-care and building our wealth and our abundance, that we are able to say no to things, people, or places that are not part of that journey. There's been an amplified focus in our community regarding our mental health and our self-care and just valuing ourselves more. And a lot of us associate the word yes with being perceived as someone who is supportive. I want to challenge you as well as myself to continue to embrace your focus on mental health, continuing to embrace your focus on self-care. And in addition to that, ignite your ability as part of your self-care to demonstrate confidence and strength by setting boundaries and simply using your power of using and saying the word no.
This has been Truth Takes on the new 101.7 The Truth. Listen to The Truth Be Told with DT and Telly weekdays from 7 a.m. to 9 a.m.
This Associated Bank Sports Update on 101.7 The Truth is powered by ESPN Milwaukee. I'm Julian Johnson. The Milwaukee Bucks are now 3-2 without Giannis as they lose to the Boston Celtics Wednesday night. They fly back home for redemption in a back-to-back game versus the Brooklyn Nets at Fiserv Forum. Coverage begins at 6 p.m. on our sister station, 620 WTMJ. Tip-off at 6:30. The number 2-seeded Marquette Golden Eagles face off against 15-seed Western Kentucky in the first round of the NCAA tournament. Coverage begins Friday at 12:30 with a 1 p.m. tip-off on 94.5 ESPN. And also in the South region, the number 5-seeded Wisconsin Badgers face off against the 12-seeded James Madison Dukes. Game starts Friday at 8:40. This sports update is presented by Associated Bank, proudly supporting our hometown teams, member FDIC.
This is the Tory Lowe Show on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com. Truth Nation, it's time to start jamming with juice. This is the Pop Culture Report with Kerry Noni and Ben Jammin on the Tory Lowe Show. Tap in to see what's trending today on Pop Culture Report.
101.7 The Truth, Tory Lowe Show. Pop Culture Report brought to you by Kerry, Noni, Juice, Juice World in the building.
Yeah, I was keeping it juicy, y'all. What's
How you doing, Juice?
Well? I'm doing good.
Ben jamming out on assignment.
Right. Ben just wanted to ditch us. You know what I'm saying? Geek on for a minute, too, on assignment, I should say. But you already know I'm going to hold it down for the Pop Culture Report with Jamming with Juice on the Tory Lowe Show. But yeah, I'm excited to be here.
But we got this though. You know, I want to definitely dive in because I asked a question.
Yeah.
You know, and to some it may seem like it's a lot of wording, but I guess nowadays with all these pronouns, it's just a lot of words flying around. But I'm trying to make it simple. You know, I'm trying to simplify the question. You mm-hmm. know, and the question was, can a trans woman who's mm-hmm. dating a man?
Mm-hmm.
give advice to a woman about how to keep a man.
Because mm-hmm.
I'm seeing this on Instagram. I'm right. seeing it on the social media
yeah,
feed.
Yeah.
Charles, your lunch is ready. I'm seeing all this stuff going on. And multiple, even I've also seen trans men
mm-hmm.
who date women
yep.
try to give advice to men how to keep, you know.
Yeah.
So it's like this whole hodgepodge
right.
going on. But can, because I think I see a lot of the trans women hairstyles,
okay.
like the way they wear their wigs,
mm-hmm.
the way they wear their eyelashes.
The influence. Mm-hmm.
And even the way they dance, because mm-hmm. it's more aggressive, feeding into the culture.
Right.
What's happening then?
I'm going to say, and you know, I had to sit with it and think with it, but I'm going to say, yes, they can give advice.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to say they can give advice only because at the end of the day.
You going to take the advice.
It could work. And the reason why I say it could work is I look at a lot of these women today and they like having gay male friends, right?
Mm.
And these gay male friends are giving them tea on how men are, how men act, you know, because at the end of the day, they're still a man. Like, they know. They know.
Okay, so you telling me that he can give you better advice on how to deal with a man?
Better, but I'm talking about he could give advice that could work. Just like single women give married women advice.
Would you take that advice?
But sometimes it do work.
Okay, so this is why I wanted to have this conversation.
It's based off of experience.
Because I do see an influence. That's why I'm asking.
Yeah.
I do see the influence that they're having on the culture.
Yeah.
As far as fashion. As far as like viral videos, things like that, where people are, more accepting of like, okay, I can take this advice.
Yeah, but you can.
But you would think a woman would know or have better understanding on how to deal with a man. But they're saying, but basically, I guess
it's those instincts to me.
You would think that the woman would be giving them the advice.
I mean, we can too. I think it's vice versa. I guess for me, I can get advice from anybody depending on what it is. Now, it also depends on what that advice is, because if they're over here saying like, oh, you don't got to do this, you don't have to make his plate, he should be bound down to you. If it's that type of advice, then no.
But you can get that from a regular woman.
Exactly. So, but if it's like real life advice, like, no, this is how men feel, you know, or this is how men want to be treated, or this is how They might know because
you saying they got one. You saying they got one, so
they're dating a man. At the end of the day, those manly instincts, in my opinion, don't just go away overnight. So they potentially could give some type of good advice. Now, do I think it's better or do I think it's worse? Yeah, I mean, it depends on what that advice is, because you got regular people giving out advice and it's trash advice.
So you just saying that if it sound right, you may add it to your.
Yes, because you can learn from anybody. You can learn from anybody.
I do agree that people can drop knowledge, but I'll tell you this. When you talk about men dating other men or dating, other ideas outside of women. Well, if y'all listening to the trans woman, why the man be like, well, I might as well go get me a trans woman then.
But that might not be what they into.
If you looking like wearing your hair like that, if you dressing like that, you just making it, you just looking like them.
Listen, I think it's more than just a look though. It goes down to your morals and your values and what you willing to. Are you willing to go to the take that house?
Oh wow.
You know, it's like what are you willing to do in the take that mansion? It goes down to your values and your morals. If you're not into dating trans people, no matter if a woman looks like a person who could be trans, but you're not going to go that far.
But it seems like I think it's always been going on, but I think that since we got social media and people are now starting to get paid for content, that we seeing a overload of this.
Yeah. And T-Lo, I took your advice and I went to their Miss Netta and Charles' Instagram page and I was just looking at it and I want to know, why are people even watching this? Like, what is so entertaining about Miss Netta and Charles? Because to me, I'm not hitting the follow button.
Okay, for those who don't understand who Miss Netta and Charles is, I guess it's a trans
woman
dating a guy.
Yeah.
But I think they about to get a reality show.
Right. That's at least that's how they're acting.
Right.
And filming they're already filming it.
And it'll pretty soon, y'all, it's going to be on the network television. But what I'm saying is, I'm seeing not only that situation, but multiple ideas where they have now, they got pants now, like where the zipper is around the butt, and you can unzip the butt where it flap out.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Like a onesie type situation how they used to have little buttons in the back.
It's like jeans.
Yeah, but it's
but they got the zipper going across this,
And, that's crazy.
And Elizabeth Brown sent me that, and I looked at it, and I was like, what? Like, what is this? And, these are the new fashion ideas that's coming out. So is that, what is this stuff? I mean, it's starting to, and
it's progressive.
And I know, here we go with the progressive. Hey, all I'm saying is, we are living in times where some people may be out of touch with what's going on with the culture.
Yeah.
So about time they see it, they nephew
but see, I guess,
and niece doing it, and then they like, oh, where did this come from?
But, right.
I think that we need to have these discussions because where are we at? I mean, I know live and let live, fine. But mm-hmm. what I'm saying is when you see a bunch of it and it's young people driven.
Right.
Then you got to talk about it.
You know, you definitely have to talk about it. I think the biggest thing is to have conversations with your children. You know, make sure you are right. raising them right and teaching them the things that you want them to know and the things that you want them to understand. Because once they get out here in this world and they're on social media and they have a cell phone right. in their hand, they are
open to everything,
to literally everything. So that's why now it's more important than ever for parents to be extra involved with their children and what's going on in their day-to-day lives. And you're really instilling those values and those morals or what, no matter what it is, well, no matter what it is, whatever you feel like your child should know or whatever you want them to know about this world, about how it's moving or whatever, you need to teach them that.
Right. And I think that many times when we talk about teaching our children, now they got these tablets. Like I was talking about Gracie's Corner, they got Big Frida on there now. Big Frida is on there. And a lot of people, like, I was shocked to see it because, you know, I see that the young people are watching these things. And so you have to teach, or if you have ideologies that are different from that, you got to make sure that you are consistently giving an understanding to your family how you want it to work.
Yeah, especially when you see, like, how the world is going. You know, like, y'all already know this, Truth Nation. I'm a firm believer in Jesus. I'm going to say that. I don't care what everybody else got going on. That's just what I believe.
Right, that's what you was taught.
And so even though, you know, the world
the
might
black
be
Jesus or white
away,
Jesus?
The black Jesus.
Oh, okay.
Even though
just, I had to check.
Even though the world is going into one direction and it's, you know, getting away from the church and getting away from the idea of, you know, just these values and morals that were instilled into me, I'm still gonna have to believe in that and teach that to my children,
right.
even though that's not the popular belief or that's not the popular opinion.
Right.
And I have to be fine with that, to understand that this is just the way the world is going. And honestly, how it was put in the Bible, in my opinion, I mean, this was all said it was gonna happen this
right.
way. So it's almost
you
like
you just got
we
the popcorn
prepared.
And the soda.
Yeah, we were prepared for this. So right. we just watching it all kind of unfold, and we got to make sure our bonds are strong and the things, our messages are strong with the people who are in our core group that we interact with on the day to day.
Well, I want you to hear this song that's out here.
Oh, gosh.
And tell me what you think about it.
Okay.
I only cook for you. Charge your lunch is ready. They hating on you. Charge your lunch is ready. And I got the dessert too.
All right.
Hey,
now this is a trans woman.
The beat is nice.
Talking to a man named Charles. She made a song. It's all over the internet. I think she said she referred to him as the husband, but I don't know.
Yeah,
but I know
they together.
They together. But what I'm saying is, these are the cultural ideas that are out here, and they give advice to how to keep a man and things like that.
Yeah.
And I think that when I heard the song, I was laughing because how they got famous was that Miss Netta would go and give Charles food.
Womanly
and record
duties.
It. Yeah, she. Doing the womanly things that most women say they don't want to do.
Mm-hmm.
And they went viral because Charles was young looking and they don't know how Charles got with somebody that looked like Shannon Sharp with a wig on.
And bruh. You know, for the longest, I did hear that they were wondering, was she a woman or was she a man? Like,
right.
They didn't even know for the longest, and she wasn't addressing it at first.
Right.
But I guess it is a trans woman.
Right. Yeah. Miss Nettie.
Yeah.
But what I'm saying is now she's giving advice. She's going on tours.
Mm-hmm. She getting this money.
And she may have a reality show. They filming
right.
things. And they got a BBL.
But see,
they went and got the BBL that looked crazy.
And I understand this is black culture.
Right.
You know, and we talk about the things going on in black culture.
Right.
But similarly to how we talked about, like, this whole baddie show on Zeus.
Right.
We don't have to consume it. You know, we don't have to watch it. We don't have to give eyes to it so they can make more money.
But what I'm saying is it's going viral in the culture with the young people.
Mm-hmm.
So what I'm saying is it's happening, and I think that every time we see things moving around in the culture, we need to discuss it.
We do, and the
because
thing that
then
I wanna...
to let the you know, because sometimes we'll not see things in the culture,
mm-hmm.
not talk about it, but by the time we see it, it's in front of us, on top of us, and
yeah.
we're reacting
yeah.
to it.
So I think the conversation that should happen is we need to be teaching people or telling people what they should or shouldn't give energy to so it doesn't spread as much.
Or make
is.
Them understand the logic and the reasoning, it. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Because every time you tell somebody not to do something,
they gonna want
to
do it.
That's exactly what they gonna
like,
do.
Don't touch that hot stove. Then you touch that hot stove.
I got burnt. Because
then you know.
You was curious, right?
Yeah.
But I think education and understanding is always the way to go.
For sure.
Because once you give them the knowledge and the understanding of something, then it's their choice.
Yep. And you know, when you brought up the tablets for a second, because I don't have kids, as y'all know, but I just wonder what I will be like as a mom with these tablets and these programs to let these kids watch. But I just wonder, what is it doing to their mind, you know, mm-hmm. by constantly having these screens in their faces, by constantly being entertained with just constant moving screens, constant shows. I just don't think that is healthy at all. But this is just part of it.
Hey, look, when we come back, we'll have more Pop Culture Report with Kerry Noni Juice. Truth Nation. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
The Tory Lowe Show returns after this on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, join the Truth team on Saturday, April 13th for our third annual Tory Lowe Community Cleanup. We want you to go to truthcommunitycleanup.com to sign up and be a volunteer to help keep Milwaukee clean. Everyone who joins will get a free lunch provided by Cousin Subs. Register today at truthcommunitycleanup.com. That is truthcommunitycleanup.com to clean and beautify our city together. The Truth Community Cleanup is sponsored by Cousin Subs.
For the brave men and women of our United States military, it's been said, some gave all, but all gave some. Here at Tabak Law, we honor these sacrifices by working to ensure veterans receive the benefits they're entitled to. I'm Jim Brzezinski, partner and VA-accredited representative at Tabak Law. If you're a vet and have been wrongfully denied or feel that your condition was not properly evaluated by the VA, visit TabakAttorneys.com to set up a free evaluation. At Tabak Law, we fight for those who fought for us. Contact Tabak for the payback. TabakAttorneys.com.
Associated Bank knows your small business isn't just a venture. It's your dream and a vital part of the community. And we're not just a bank. We're your neighbors. We're looking out for you. That's why Associated Bank offers quick online applications and approvals with funding in as fast as one business day, checking with no minimum balances or maintenance fees, and prompt customer service. Explore our products at associatedbank.com/business or visit a branch for more details. Subject to credit approval. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Protect your dream home with American Family Insurance. And you can weather any storm. You'll also save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote. Find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Milwaukee's favorite station.
Please, please, Lisa, please, for the love of Jehovah, don't kick me or anybody with a prosthetic leg. Please. Why do I even gotta say please? Because what if you kick me and it falls off? I ain't gonna pick it up. You try to kick me. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna hit you with your own leg. I'll teach you a lesson.
Coming with Straight Truth.
And you know what? If you want to make it about race, I need you to hold your black men accountable. Don't let these black men get away with anything. Because what does that say about you? Because if you're going to be that person who's not going to hold your own people accountable, we have nothing to talk about. I'm sorry. That's a real old school mentality, my guy.
Tune in to all your favorite 1017 The Truth shows all day, every day by downloading the Truth app.
We got to get back into common courtesy.
Mm-hmm.
It's about the family structure.
Right. It is.
Our extended family, we are all family in Milwaukee. Come on now.
Watch all your favorite 1017 The Truth shows by subscribing to 1017 The Truth on YouTube.
You are listening to The Tory Lowe Show on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Roll another one.
Sit up, never like you know it's special pack it with the automatics. We gon' set up tatted. Wait.
1017 The Truth, Tory Lowe Show. DJ Brother Z on the ones and twos. Pop Culture Report brought to you by Carrie, Noni, Juice. Juice World in the building.
Yeah, yeah, I was keeping it juicy, y'all.
Okay, so Jamming with Juice is coming.
Well, we are trying to get Jamming with Juice coming. You okay. know, like,
what's going on with this Jamming with Juice?
We've been doing Jamming with Juice for a while now, as everybody knows.
Right.
You know, and we come in on the Pop Culture Report. Right. But we are ready to have a show. Mm-hmm. All right. Me and Ben, we are ready to have a show, and we are trying to convince our bosses, the lovely
the
people
suits.
Of Good Karma Brands, yes, the suits, that it's about time that we get our own show. So if you guys have not already heard the promo that is running on March, 28th, next week Thursday, mm-hmm. 1 week from today, we want you guys, it's kind of like a campaign. We're campaigning, and we want everybody of Truth Nation who has listened to me and Ben together, you know, whenever we're filling in for Ms. Melanie Riggs on Nothing But the Truth, and whenever we are on this Tory Lowe Show doing the Pop Culture Report with Jamming with Juice.
Oh.
Anybody who loves listening to us or who has called in or who just like more content from us, we need you guys to call in all day on March 28th. That is next week, Thursday. Literally, we want you to bombard all of the shows all day long.
Even the Tory Lowe Show? You
Even
want Truth Nation?
Even the Tory Lowe Show.
You want Truth Nation to tap in?
I need y'all to tap in and tell everybody on these airwaves how much you would like Jamming with Juice as a show, and we're gonna see what happens. That's
you know
really
what
we're doing.
I love to see the future of radio, Black Talk Radio, radio period, because that's what I'm watching.
Yeah.
You know, it's a lot of great young people working here, like doing things, creatives, and I can't wait to see the next 10 years where y'all will stand in as far as the Black media culture.
Yeah, it's exciting because really Milwaukee is, I mean, we've been saying this for a few years now, but Milwaukee is really on the come up.
Right.
We've got three Milwaukee artists right now on the top 50 billboard for TikTok. The TikTok billboard 50, top 50. Yeah, three of our
right.
local artists are on that, you know, have those spots.
And I know that JP...
Yep, you got JP.
Frank.
Yeah, Big Frank.
Big Frank.
For Big Frank. And we got Certified Trapper as well.
Certified Trapper, that's
but
right.
There's a lot of other people too. You know, you got Party at Four. You got Lakia doing her thing. We got Huey V. We got Wade Chappelle.
Right. And they all then came through
Chicken
here.
Chicken P. You know,
we gotta get
so
Chicken P to come
many
through.
People.
Right.
A.O. Lee. Like, I could go on and on and on.
And don't forget Lakia. She,
yeah, I said,
she
yeah,
been
I got
out
Lakia,
here. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, Maya P, too. So
Maya
we got
P,
so,
right.
so many talented people from Milwaukee who are really doing their thing. And I think now
Haley
is the
Crossfire,
time,
too.
Exactly.
Right.
Now is the time to have a show similar to, you know, me and Ben Jamming, the Jamming with Juice,
mm-hmm.
to, you know, bring these young people on and really elevate what is going on in the culture, not even just locally, but nationally as well.
I agree.
You know, we do a really great job of trying to make you guys feel comfortable to call in, and we're not going to bash you for how you feel about nothing. You know, it's all good fun and entertainment. You know
right.
what I'm saying? Like, we had a show before where I had asked the question, and it was a little crazy. I hope people didn't care, but, you know, would you, if you were a slave on a boat, would you stay on the boat, be a slave, or would you jump off in the water? What would you do?
I'm jumping in the water.
You're
I already know
in the water.
By my behavior, the way
yep.
I am now,
yep.
yeah, I already know I would have jumped in
exactly.
the water. I'd have been, hey, look, I'd have had to wrestle with the sharks or whatever. You know, I'd have probably been, you know, it would have been done with because
no, for sure.
I could just tell by the way I live what I'm doing now.
Yep.
Yeah, I would have definitely jumped over.
Yeah, so we have these different interesting discussions, and we just want to continue these conversations on our own show. So if you love us, if you want to hear more from us, we are leaving it in the hands of the people to let our guys.
How many callers? How many callers y'all need to just to bombard just Truth
just,
Nation?
Just bombard as many as we possibly can on March 28th. That is next week, Thursday,
hey.
All day long. We'll try to call in.
Are we having a celebration?
Yeah, it's going to be a celebration. If we get the show, it's for sure
hey,
going to be a celebration.
That's we're going to go out into the Third Street Market Hall
yeah, turn
and turn up.
Hey. Because we have so many ideas of things that we want to do. And so we just want to make sure it's the right fit and that it's wanted by the community
right.
as well. It
I
can't
agree.
Just be what we want. It has to be what the community wants as well. So,
and I agree. Over the years, I've actually had the honor to watch the development over the years.
Mm-hmm.
And like I said, I'm excited. Like,
yeah.
we have some great young talent right here working in the Truth, in GKB. And I say you always do 5-year plans, you do 10-year plans. And I can see the future of what's going to happen in the next 10 years right around me right now.
Yeah, I love that. That is so. That is the confirmation right there. Because, you know, you can feel it within yourself a little bit, but you always wonder, like, what are other people thinking? You know, so for you to say that, mm-hmm. and, you know, you've seen us from the very beginning.
Right.
Literally 3 years ago, once the truth, you know, initially launched, and Ben and I have grown so, so much. And
right.
we think it's time. We think it's time to turn it up, keep it juicy, and right. keep it amazing.
And the Nassis, y'all got an interview with the Nassis.
We do have an interview with the Nassis.
The brother of Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Mm-hmm.
Is where is that? That's on.
It's on our YouTube.
It's on the YouTube.
Yep, it dropped yesterday. So Thanasis came through earlier this week. He is promoting his live podcast. He has a podcast. It's called Thanalysis. He is doing a live podcast tomorrow at
right.
Potawatomi. Doors open at 6, event starts at 7, and he's interviewing his brother Giannis. So him and Giannis will be there and some special guests, but we got to keep it closed. We can't
right.
say who's coming. But it's going to be a really great time. So the Nassis came and he was promoting the event. Make sure you guys get your tickets. I believe the link is called TAShowLive.com. I don't want to be wrong, but I think it's TAShowLive.com. Mm. Make sure you guys.
I'll definitely do the read for that to
yeah,
make sure that everybody
got. It's either TAShowLive or TA Live Show. It's TA Live Show.
Mm.
That's what it is.
Yeah, TA Live Show.
TAShowLive.com.
To get the tickets.
Get your tickets. And so, yeah, and if you want to catch that interview that Ben and I did with the Nassis, it was actually really cool. We talked about Greek mythology. We talked about Elon Musk. We talked about technology and AI. It really wasn't even about basketball, which was really cool. So make sure you guys check that out.
And that's how the podcast. Should be. It should have a sprinkle of basketball, yep. but it should have some innovative ideas yeah. as well.
And he said it felt like a podcast too. So it was great. Check it out on the Truth YouTube.
Well, Juice, I appreciate you for coming through.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Hey, look, I'll talk to you soon.
Of course. See you
right.
later, Truth Nation.
Truth Nation, when we come back, we'll have more conversations. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
Truth Nation, Dr. Ken Harris here, and I'm excited about the Truth's partnership with Versity. There is a serious need for blood donations in the Black community, and Versity wants to bring awareness to this because it's their mission to improve patient outcomes, advance the field of personalized medicine, and strengthen the health of communities everywhere. This is why you should tune in every month when a representative from Versity joins the Truth to share about what they're doing to make a difference in our community.
1017 The Truth and Associated Bank have teamed up for our Black-owned business give back. Each quarter, we'll be giving away $6,000 worth of free commercial advertising for 3 months to 5 Black businesses. To sign up for your business's chance to win $6,000 of commercial campaign marketing on the award-winning 1017 The Truth, visit blackbusinessgiveback.com. That's blackbusinessgiveback.com. Let's rebuild our community's backbone through exposure on The Truth. For official rules, head to blackbusinessgiveback.com. Associated Bank, member FDIC.
Pollution from trucks is a public health crisis. Diesel-burning trucks belch dangerous levels of pollution, and communities living near ports and along freight corridors breathe especially high levels of this dirty air. But this crisis has a solution. My name is Sasan Sadat, and I work for Earth Justice. I'm working to clean up our air quality, particularly for communities that bear the burden of diesel pollution. For the sake of our lungs, our health, and our climate, the future of trucking in this country has got to be zero emissions. Until then, I will never rest.
Earth Justice is a national legal nonprofit defending the environment and people's health. Earth Justice is fighting to save lives, protect our climate, and strengthen our economy through the shift to zero emissions. If clean air matters to you, visit us at earthjustice.org. Earth Justice, because the earth needs a good lawyer.
Donors choose. Support a classroom.
Build a future.
Did you know that every year, public school teachers spend nearly $500 of their own money for student supplies? Let's do the math. That comes out to over $1.2 billion a year. And that's just not right. At Donors Choose, we want students and teachers to have the tools they need for a great education. And now, more than ever, they need your help. Here's what you can do. Go to donorschoose.org and choose from teachers' requests that support reading, math, science, history, and more. Once a request is funded, we'll take care of shipping everything directly to the teacher. It's that easy. You'll receive thank you letters and photos from students and teachers and a report of how every dollar was spent. Teachers' needs have never been greater. Learn more at donorschoose.org.
Donors Choose. Support a classroom.
Build a future.
Truth Nation, stand up and tap in. This is 1017 FM, 1510 AM WGKB Waukesha and W269 DL Milwaukee, a locally owned Good Karma brand station. This is your 1017 The Truth News Update.
Hello, everyone. This is Rhea Riley with your news update. Demolition on the formerly known Northridge Mall began yesterday. The demolition was met with protesters advocating for proper pay as it began to break ground. According to the protester Mike Irvin, a local 139 member, the construction workers and heavy machinery operators were not being paid the proper wages for this project. According to Fox 6 Milwaukee, the demolition is funded using $15 million from the American Rescue Plan Act. The mall was purchased by the city. However, Mayor Johnson Cavalier states there are no certain plans for the property quite yet. The current goal is to have the entire property completely demolished by fall of 2025. Milwaukee police are asking for help to locate a missing 21-year-old woman named Brittany Thurmond. According to the police, Thurmond was last seen yesterday around 10:30 a.m. near Hampton and Sherman. It has also been alleged that she was with a man named Alfred Savoy. Savoy drives a 2021 black Honda Civic with temporary plates U727ZE. Thurmond is around 5'6" and weighs 150 pounds with medium-length black hair. If you have any information, call MPD's 7th District at 414-935-7272. Two Milwaukee Department of Public Works employees have pled guilty to federal charges of embezzlement. The employees Kelly Whitmore Bailing and Kyle Kep were accused of embezzling more than $100,000 from the city and later used it to gamble at Pottawatomie Casino. Their roles for the DPW were to maintain a fleet of city-owned vehicles and equipment. In 2022, they were able to accomplish this crime by selling the surplus of the property. According to the prosecutors, they sold the property they oversaw through DPW for less than the market value. The two have agreed to pay restitution to a total amount of $357,000. The DPW has yet to comment on whether they are still employed. This has been your news update. The Tory Lowe Show continues on the new 1017 The Truth.
We need each other.
That's facts.
I need my sisters. I need my brothers out here.
A coward dies a thousand deaths, and for all the bootlickers, may you die 1,001.
The place for the realest conversations.
Tory Lowe, want all the action? Or you want all the smoke? Oh, just me.
I'm with all that smoke too, man.
I didn't see Ron Johnson. He trash. Chisholm is trash. How the hell are you here to help us and your kids are dying in the street?
I understand that this is Milwaukee and everybody believes that if someone says something, it's snitching. It's not.
I don't care if it's the pastor. If you see the pastor acting right, you check that fool. Where's the results?
Talking topics that need to be highlighted and discussed in our communities.
Would you trade places with a black person?
No, I would not.
Have you ever said the N-word?
I'm not.
Come on, be the truth.
Ready?
We are the truth.
Unfiltered and unfazed, this is the Tory Lowe Show on 1017 The Truth and The Truth App.
The reason I believe that racism is getting worse is because whites know that they will be outnumbered in about 20, 21 years. They're going to be outnumbered.
Hey, Tory, man. How are you doing, brother? I'm actually from India. We brown people can totally relate with you. And sometimes it's like, did that just happen to me?
We have to not let the government mind F us either.
That cop ain't never been brought to the public because he ain't normal, and he may not even exist no more.
Say no more. Release the video.
You know, you keep on doing what you're doing, man. You're going to take over this talk radio, man. Just keep on focusing on what you're focusing on. I wish you a lot of love.
God bless you, brother.
Now, live from the American Family Insurance Studio in Milwaukee, here is Tory Lowe.
White people, I got crying.
Justice Wisconsin, the truth. The most requested advocate in the state. 101.7 FM. The movement continues. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, Milwaukee, stand up, stand up. It's Tory Lowe, the truth, from one to four. We about that action, so tap in and let's go. We want that justice, we want all the smoke. From Monday through Friday, trying to bring the city hope. Yeah, Tory Lowe from one to four, Monday through Friday, let's go. We about that action from the block, and we ready, let's go. Tap in, and it ain't no holding back, we ready. We ready. 1017, the truth. Tory Lowe, Tory Lowe Show, live from American Family Insurance Studio at the Avenue. The movement continues. The marathon continues right here on 1017 The Truth. Thank you for joining me for the second hour of the Tory Lowe Show. And today we got guests. We got Yadaya Israel He is a representative for the Youth Violence Conflict Resolution Seminar that's happening tomorrow.
Tonight. Yes, sir.
Tonight from 5.
Yes, sir.
To 8.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that's happening tonight. And also we got Job Israel in the building. And this event is a Stop the Violence event.
It is, sir.
Where we'll be talking to the youth at the Boys and Girls Club. And I was also asked to talk for 15 minutes as well. So I'll definitely be there.
We would love to have you.
Yeah. Hey, look, I appreciate y'all for coming through because violence is a huge issue in our community.
It is.
Facts.
And why did y'all decide to have this right now?
Well, no better time than the present. As you know, Milwaukee is starting off this year already, 24 homicides. And that's not even including people who have been shot who were not murdered.
Right.
From 2020 to 2023, almost 200 homicides. So we're looking at about every 3 or 4 days, somebody is getting put into a casket. Somebody is dying before their time, before they're able to reach maturity, before they're able to even get to the age where they finally get to understand life. So we're trying to be that bridge where we can give people what we didn't have growing up. Mm-hmm. Because we come from these same communities.
Right.
Our people didn't have the proper understanding. So we're trying to show our people that the solution is in the scriptures. So we're trying to give them what we didn't have to equip them to be functional in society.
That's what's up. And how important has your faith been in your journey? Because y'all are young people.
Yes, sir.
Y'all use the teachings and the moral base as a guide.
Yes.
100%.
Israel united in Christ.
Yes, sir.
What is that? What kind of, explain that.
Okay, yes. So Israel United in Christ is a Bible-based, faith-based organization started in 2003 by our elder, Bishop Nathaniel. And from his vision that he had with the Spirit of the Lord upon him, it has transcended into a global movement mm-hmm. of people who believe in the Lord God, Jesus the Christ, keep the commandments. And that's the real change that we need in our communities.
Right.
Because in order for you to say you believe in the Lord, you must apply what is written. Can't pick and choose.
Right.
You know, so we are a product of the scriptures, but we would never had that if those men didn't step up to the plate. So we're a product of men of faith. That's what we are. We are a product of their faith and their works, because faith without works is dead. So we're now coming up under their tutelage, and we're doing the same thing they did. We're
mentorship.
Yes. So we're putting in the work, and we're reaching the community, and we're trying to build that bridge and equip the youth to have what we didn't have.
What bothers you the most when you see what's going on in our communities with the young people, with the violence? Mm-hmm. What bothers you the most, and what is something that you want to change communities?
What bothers me the most is the hatred that we have for each other, because we know the crime, the murders, the stabbings, all the violence that takes place, the assaults, the jumpings, the beatings, all those things are just a reflection of that self-hatred. Mm-hmm. Once we have that love for self and that love for ourselves as a people, because we still suffer in trauma from we share a collective trauma from what has happened to us. We have not healed as a people.
Right.
All right. And the Bible is the healing that we need. So
the spiritual.
Exactly. So once we meet them where they are and we give them the solutions that they need, we can stop the self-hatred, because we have a lot to love in ourselves. We shouldn't have that vacant esteem or that low self-esteem that we have. Mm-hmm. But that hatred, that self-hatred and that low self-esteem, It's the foundation for a lot of the violence and the hatred that we have and the contention in the communities, the gangs and all those things. Once we restore that identity and sense of self, then we'll start to see a change in our communities.
What do you believe is the reasoning for the self-hatred that I hate my brother, we're not working together to getting things done or being productive? Why do you feel the self-hatred is there?
Well, number one, give me Proverbs 23. I'm gonna bring on it, because everything we do is based upon the Bible. So I do want to read this verse real quick.
Go right ahead, do your thing.
Proverbs 23, start at verse 7, real quick, Job.
Yes, sir. This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 23, and verse 7.
Mm-hmm.
For as he thinketh in his heart, so is he.
The Bible says, as a man or woman think in their heart, so are they.
Mm.
So if I'm being conditioned in society to think that I'm a boy, if I'm being conditioned to think that I'm shiftless, I'm no good, I'm a thug or a thot, if everything around me is molding and conditioning me to be that way, my actions will show fruit of what I have been taught and force-fed to believe. But when we teach them, no, you're a son of the living God, you're a daughter of the living God, our history is in the Bible.
Mm-hmm.
Everything that happened, all nations are found in the Bible, including us. And when we identify who we are in the Bible, we see we have a rich heritage. We descend from great men, holy and righteous men. Now we have a foundation. And now we have somebody who we can model ourselves after. We can model ourselves after Abraham, after Isaac, after David, after Solomon. So that's what we're trying to restore to the people, that hole in their soul that's missing, which is the identity.
Yadaya Israel.
Yes, sir.
I want to ask you, how do you compete nowadays with what's going on in the community with their hip hop? I don't even know what this new wave is. Is everybody going to jail? They get so fast they get the contract.
Yes,
but they're out here going viral. It's spreading amongst the youth.
Mm-hmm.
How do you compete against that? What is the strategy to say, hey, this is the way?
Mm-hmm.
And how do you implement that?
Right. So a lot of what we do, we're very hands on in the community.
Right.
The youth violence conflict resolution is one branch to the many different resources and many different agendas that we have under IUIC. IUIC has the youth violence. We're also in the community. We're doing cleanups, and we also have mentorship programs where we're teaching men how to be men, how to be productive in society. Like this brother right here, he graduated the 300 program. He has the pin on his shirt. So our leadership has put many different avenues in place to reach the people and show them a better way. But in regards to the music, we have our own music. So we have
y'all got rap music.
Yes, yes. We have rap that's based upon.
Y'all should have sent us a sample of it.
Yeah, we got plenty of it.
You got to send him the link
of it.
So original royalty. Yes, sir.
And that's what's up, DJ Brother. We may have to get some of this sample of what they putting out there to combat this with the rap music.
We're going to get it directly to you. A lot of it, too. We got different genres, singing, rap, poetry.
Can you find it on YouTube?
Yes.
What do you look up?
Original Royalty.
Original Royalty?
Yep. YouTube channel is called Original Royalty. Go to videos, and we got a slew. And we put our artists pound for pound against anybody.
What?
Yes.
Line it up.
Yes, sir.
Line it up.
Yes, sir.
They can go number one on the charts.
They can go number one on the charts. But the difference is we're not going to compromise our values.
No, you don't have to. if it's slick.
Oh, yeah.
If it's dope, it doesn't matter.
Pound for pound.
And you know what we call it? Truth music.
Truth? What?
That's right.
Truth music.
Puff!
Truth music.
Hey, look.
That's right.
I'm going to tell you right now, when we talk about violence in young people and things that are in our communities, I think that many times when you talk about people who commit violence, they get in a desperate state, you know, and they get, you know, maybe they have no other logic or anything to lean on to judge why they're taking these actions. Because many times when we talk about what we've been taught, it's to strike out first and then face the repercussions later.
Mm-hmm.
Hey,
we were just saying that.
Go to Isaiah 51 and 20, because that's in the Bible. A lot of times we look at this book and we disassociate ourselves from it.
Mm-hmm.
But exactly what you just said, it was already written. So get that real quick, and then I want to continue this dialogue. Read that quickly, Isaiah 51 and 20.
Isaiah chapter, you said 58?
51 and 20, please.
51 and 20, excuse me. The book Isaiah chapter 51 and verse 20.
Let's read the prophecy about our men in these last days. Go ahead.
It says, thy sons have fainted.
So when it says they have fainted, it don't mean literally fainting. It means that we have lost knowledge of self. We have lost consciousness. We're not conscious in these last days. Go ahead.
They lie at the head of all the streets.
What's the head of the street? That's the corner. We on a corner. We're gangbanging. We're pantsagging. We're selling drugs. We're doing drugs. We putting our women on the stroll, and we got them selling their bodies, and different things is going on these corners. It says they lie at the head of all the streets. Go ahead.
As a wild bull in a net.
So when you examine the attributes of a wild bull, they are very violent. You don't want to come around a wild bull.
Or a young bull.
Exactly. So God likens us in these last days to a wild bull in a net. Go ahead.
They are full of the fury of the Lord, the rebuke of thy God.
So we are suffering as a people, and we don't know why we're suffering. A wild bull in the net, he's desperate. He's in a trap. Ain't that what we call we call the trap, right?
Right.
That's us. We're those wild bulls in the trap, and we're frustrated. And a lot of times we take that frustration out on those closest to us.
Mm-hmm.
Hurt people. You know, so we all share a collective trauma. And then who suffers that trauma firsthand? Our own brother, our own sisters. So we're showing them, listen, everything that's going on is Bible prophecy, and the solutions are also found in his Bible.
100%.
Well, look, we're going to run the break. And when we come back, I want to talk about the event that's coming up tonight.
Yes,
5 p.m. to 8 p.m. at the Boys and Girls Club. It's free.
It's free.
For all.
It's free for all.
And it's a stop the violence event?
Yes, sir.
Look, Truth Nation, when we come back, we'll have more conversations. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
Truth Nation, Dr. Ken Harris here, and I'm excited about the Truth partnership with Versity. There is a serious need for blood donations in the Black community, and Versity wants to bring awareness to this because it's their mission to improve patient outcomes, advance the field of personalized medicine, and strengthen the health of communities everywhere. This is why you should tune in every month when a representative from Versity joins the Truth to share about what they're doing to make a difference in our community.
Associated Bank knows your small business isn't just a venture. It's your dream and a vital part of the community. And we're not just a bank. We're your neighbors. We're looking out for you. That's why Associated Bank offers quick online applications and approvals with funding in as fast as one business day, checking with no minimum balances or maintenance fees, and prompt customer service. Explore our products at associatedbank.com/business or visit a branch for more details. Subject to credit approval. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
After a serious crash with a semi-truck, everything can change instantly. Your future, your family's future, your quality of life. That's why knowledge and results matter in big truck cases. And not all law firms have the know-how or the resources to handle these complicated cases. At Grunberg Law Offices, we have the experience it takes to make sure you're protected. And there's never a fee until we win your case. Grunberg Law Offices. One call, that's all.
My name is Lieutenant Finkley, and I am more than an officer. Working with the youth as a juvenile corrections officer, I saw the impact I was able to have on kids. So after some reflection, I decided to become a Milwaukee police officer. I had already served the country as a veteran, and this was my opportunity to serve humanity. And now I am more than an officer, and you can be too. Come join the Milwaukee Police Department by applying. Go online and search Milwaukee Police Department careers.
Truth Nation, it is Denise Thomas.
And Telly Hughes.
From Truth Be Told with DT and Telly. And guess what?
What is that, DT?
Our Truth fans can now watch and stream us live every day, Telly.
Wait a minute, Denise. Let me make sure I got this thing right. Our amazing and incredible Truth fans can go to 1017thetruth.com, click the Watch Live link, and watch me and you do our thing live from YouTube and Twitter every morning?
Yes, Telly, that is exactly right. So now they can watch you almost lose your black card every Friday during our Truth Telling Hit segment.
Come on now. You know I'm never losing my black card. But Truth Nation, you gotta tune into all your favorite 1017 The Truth shows, as you can not only listen live on the app, but you can also stream us live all day, every day, by going to 1017thetruth.com and clicking the Watch Live link.
You are listening to The Tory Lowe Show on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
I came from where it's drama and it's hostile. Where I'm at, we cure the trauma with the gospel. More than 12, it's like 1,000 apostles. Hit your block and then we dip like it's nachos. What's a op? We in the kitchen where they pop toast. Riding like a Tahoe, never scared of them potholes. We came to save the same ones they made a victim. Plague with the sickness, the scripture gave the prescriptions. This a doctor bag, play without the hockey mask. Came to chop up whoever, then it's a body bag. Told them we the sons of God and I got to brag. Whole hood know we in the field like where the cotton at. If he plots at haters that wanna copycat. They know my stock's the greatest, they wanna
that's
stop
me. Just patiently waiting up for the stop to that. They gonna Israel the united in Christ in the building.
That's right.
Yadaya in the building.
That's right.
Yadaya, yes, Israel in the building.
That's right.
Job Israel in the building. Yes, sir. And there is an event tonight from 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. at the Boys and Girls Club. Is what Boys and Girls Club is this? What's the address?
What's the address?
Yeah, 3,000 North Sherman. Yeah, 3,000 North
Sherman. Sherman Park, the Boys and Girls Club, yes, at Sherman
sir.
Park.
Yes, sir. Yep, yes, sir. That's the one.
And when you, who do you,
who do you want to reach? Are you talking about the community? Are you talking about the young people? Or you just want the community to just get engaged?
You know, it's heavy because it's called the Youth Violence Conflict Resolution. But, you know, a lot of times our troubled youth become troubled adults. So we want as much of the community to come out as possible. So we're promoting it. We're working hand-in-hand with the rec centers. We're working hand-in-hand on the streets. We're doing flyer missions, passing out the literature, letting them know, hey, everybody is welcome to come out because, like I said, young troubled youth turn into younger, older adults. And, you know, with the way society is shaping the people, the maturity level is not what it used to be 20 years ago. You know, they're saying 30 is a new 20, 40 is a new 30. People identify with the youth.
Right.
You got 40-year-olds in the club listening to the same rap music that 16-year-olds are listening to.
That's what
to.
I thought that it was no, there's no in between now. Everybody's listening to the same artist.
Yes.
Everybody trying to dress the same.
Yes.
You know, I remember when I was younger and I was in high school and some of my elders would come and say, hey, you the next. Mm-hmm. You know, then I grow up and they don't want to move out the way.
Right.
You know. Right. Yeah, I mean, they don't know that I saw them when I was in high school.
Right.
Coming in telling me that I was the future.
Mm-hmm.
Then when I became the future, they wasn't willing to allow me to take my place.
Wow, mm-hmm. That's deep, bro.
So that's how what I saw.
Mm-hmm.
So I said it was my turn, and I don't care how you feel about it.
Right.
It's our generation turn to teach the next generation, and some people didn't want to come up off that.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Cause I guess they was still trying to find themselves, you know, at that point.
You're absolutely right. And that's why when you read even in the book of Luke, Christ said, you know, how do I liken the men of this generation, even in his time period? Because mm-hmm. those same spirits is back today. The same things he dealt with, we have to deal with today. He said, I like them unto children in the marketplace.
Mm.
You know, meaning that very, very immature, easily swayed,
right.
easily influenced, minds very impressionable. Nowadays, our adults who are supposed to be mentoring this youth, Generation Z, and whatever they call
right.
them now, they are just as impressionable as them. You
wow.
know, they on Worldstar, they on TikTok, they on Facebook.
They on TikTok else. Doing the TikTok dances yes. and everything.
Mm-hmm. Yep. So we want.
It's no separation in maturity.
Exactly. So we want to reach everybody because everybody's being affected by it. Everybody's being affected.
Right.
You know. So you go into these prisons, you see 17 and up. You know, going in there for murders, homicides.
Right.
Sometimes we go into the prisons as well, and we teach the brothers who are facing 20, 25-year sentences, and all for something for a blink of an eye have cost them the rest of their life.
60 seconds.
You know, some of them with no option for parole either. Just for you losing your temper once, you threw away the rest of your life, you know, or 25 years of your life. So we're trying to give them the solutions so they can grow up to be fathers, so they can be husbands, and so we can raise up families and be
And y'all peace. Have a program that they can get involved in as well.
Yes, sir. So we work with the chaplains. We go in there. We mentor them. And like I said, a lot of them are facing some heavy time. But those who may have not committed murders and things worthy of 25 years, 30 years, even people in our congregation have passed. You know, so I myself— Job, a lot of us come from inner cities, whether it be Chicago, Milwaukee,
right.
and we would not be where we are today as citizens, business owners, electricians, managers, and things that we wouldn't be where we was at if it was not
without the guidance.
Exactly, in the teachings of the Bible, because that's the foundation of everything.
Mm.
You know, our leaders don't come out of their own mind. You know, everything is found in scripture. So you'll see us a lot, but like, you know, let's get that scripture because it's what we base everything off of. The foundation is the Bible.
Where's the breakdown between the youth and the older generation? Where's the miscommunication?
I think it starts in the house. I think it starts in the house. And I think that due to the irresponsibility in the Black community, in the Hispanic community, with the way we court and the way we go about relationships, there's not a lot of marriages. It's a lot of single parent households. We're being raised by the mother. The mother, she was probably come from a single parent. So it's generational.
Mm-hmm.
It's
generational curses.
Yep. Yes, sir. And 100%. Then children who are products of that are more likely to commit crimes, violent crimes. They're more likely to drop out of school, which leads to idleness, which leads to evil.
Mm-hmm.
They're more likely to go to jail. They're more likely to be suicidal. They're more likely to not go to college. So the stats don't lie. So we need to build the foundation back. Marriage must be honorable in our communities.
Right? Mm.
We have to make marriage honorable.
Sometimes I tell my son, I'd be like, I'm worried about your generation because I don't know what you about to marry because that there's no center point.
Right.
There's no plan. It's everything goes at this point.
Exactly. You got women just as free with their bodies as men were back in the 90s. You know,
right.
Talking about, I got to get a high body count. You got... That is unheard of to hear women talk like that.
Mm.
But that how society is molding towards a certain direction.
Right.
It's self-destructive. It's not a lifestyle at all.
Mm.
Right now, it's a lot of death styles being passed over as trendy.
I'll tell you this. When I look at this youth generation, I wonder, how can we reel it in and create a hub for everybody, even if you don't have family, even if you don't have support, to get the necessary resources? Because I think people talk too much, and I think that when they talk a lot, they think they're helping.
Mm-hmm.
But usually when people feel that you care, it's an action.
Yeah.
It's like taking action,
mm-hmm.
Getting results for exactly. each other and things like that. And I think we kind of got away from actually rolling up our sleeves and going into the neighborhoods and producing positive outcomes for people to go and talk about. Just like when you read the Bible, Jesus went into the people and then he touched them, or he did things where he made them see, or they were able to spread the word that there were some real results out here.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't see that kind of thing happening right now from the church or from the religious aspect. I don't even see that going on. I think that we got away from actually rolling up our sleeves.
Activism.
Handling our situations head up.
Absolutely.
I think that now everybody's so comfortable sitting back that now that the tear is this big, now they want to get in there. But now you need more help. You need more resources.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You need more things to take place for you to put it back together again.
Mm-hmm. And you're right, because back in the 60s, a lot of our leadership during that time period, they had food programs.
Yep.
They were ones who established the Women and Children Fund, which what the government has as WIC today. Our people actually established that, our leadership in the black and brown communities in the 60s. They were on the street. They were soapbox teachers. They was right there meeting the people where they were. They weren't going into a big megalithic building waiting for the people to come to them.
Mm.
So we're adopting those same things. Only difference is we're bringing back the actual Bible as it is written. We're not doing our own thing. We're not coming with our own doctrine. We don't want to be worshipped. We're right, Isaiah 30 and 20, we're right there in the streets with the people, as it's supposed to be. You know, as you said, as Christ was. Christ said, foxes have holes, but the Son of Man don't have nowhere to lay his head. Because he was traveling, doing the work. He was with the people, healing, feeding them, you know.
He was touchable.
Exactly.
It's the book of Isaiah, chapter 30 and verse 20.
What?
And though the Lord give you the bread of adversity.
Because for our people, we have the bread of adversity right now. We are struggling. We the last hire. We the first fire. We suffering God's judgment because we the ones who he made the covenant with in the beginning. So it says, though God give us the bread of adversity. Go ahead.
And the water of affliction.
Because we afflicted. We on Section 8. We on welfare, EBT. Go ahead.
Yet shall not thy teachers be removed into the corner anymore.
But people need to see us in the community. It says our teachers, the real teachers, would not be removed into a corner. We're not hiding. We're not going to be podcast talkers. We're going to be boots on the ground. If you type in IUIC in any city you can imagine, you're going to see us in the community, boots on the ground.
How many members y'all got here in Milwaukee?
We don't typically count like that, but I do know that we are growing.
Because I know, is that the guys that with the purple robes on?
Yep.
That walk with a whole bunch of people dressed the same?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Order.
We need that to walk through Milwaukee.
Yes, sir. Lord's will in due time.
Okay. I'm just trying to figure it out.
We with you. And Lord's will in due time. But just capitalize on that verse. You don't got to get it. But it said that our people's eyes will see their teachers. Because it all starts, because you can give a man $1 million, but if his man is not right, he won't know what to do.
A fool and his money will soon separate.
Oh, man, that's heavy. You know, so he won't even know how to invest it and how to make it circulate within his community. But once we can change the minds of our people with the word of God, that's when we can start talking about, hey, let's do this for our people. Because our people are more than just in the U.S. Our people are in Africa. So we are not only trying to make change locally, we're trying to make change globally, because our people are struggling in Ghana, we're struggling in Uganda, we're struggling in Sierra. So we have schools in those countries as well. And we building on different
continents.
That's
what's up.
Yes, sir.
Hey, look, when we come back, I want y'all to talk about how can we as a community get more involved in what y'all trying to do for the community.
Yes, sir.
And I think that tonight at the Boys and Girls Club in Sherman Park, we'll probably get a little bit more of the information, but at least how to tap in.
Yes, sir.
And keep up with y'all.
That'd be excellent. That'd be excellent. We would love to.
Truth Nation, when we come back, we're going to have more conversations. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
The Tory Lowe Show returns after this on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app at 1017thetruth.com.
Life's better with American Family Insurance, because our home policies help protect your dreams and come with peace of mind. Save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at amfam.com.
products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Looking for natural solutions to ease your mind and body? Find your calm and get cozy at Torch CBD with their hemp-infused teas, or boost your health with broad-spectrum CBD products. From CBD-infused cooking oil, honey and coffee, to body creams, edibles, and smokable flower. Torch CBD, located at 3419 West State Street in Milwaukee, is ready to help with all your trauma, anxiety, and sleep issues. Stop by Torch CBD today and relax your mind.
The award-winning 101.7 The Truth proudly celebrates Women's History Month. Listen to one of our incredible Truth teammates highlight the remarkable achievements of Black women throughout history.
Hey everybody, it's Melanie Ricks from the award-winning 101.7 The Truth. For Women's History Month, I want to highlight Maya Angelou for the incredible impact that she had on society. Maya Angelou, of course, most famously known for her unique and pioneering autobiographical writing style. One of her most well-known publications, I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings, was written in 1969, and it's still relevant in the year 2024. Maya Angelou was an American author, poet, civil rights activist, and she rose to prominence with the writing of that incredible and historic piece. Miss Angelou was a storyteller. She was a truth teller. She was someone who was able to bring together different groups of people simply with written word. She was someone who spoke from experience and spoke from others' experience and made sure that all Americans knew the true Black experience, and she was never afraid to speak on it and to write on it from a place of sincerity, a place of hurt. To this day, Still I Rise is one of the greatest pieces of work that I have ever read. You may write me down in history with your bitter, twisted lies. You may trod me in the very dirt, but still like dust, I'll rise. Does my sassiness upset you? Why are you beset with gloom? Because I walk like I've got oil wells pumping in my living room. Just like moons and like suns, with the certainty of tides, just like hope springing high, still, I'll rise. Thank you, Maya Angelou, for all of your contributions. Your impact is truly everlasting.
Tune in to The Truth as we celebrate the greatness of Black women all month long. The celebration of Women's History on The Truth is sponsored by the Milwaukee Police Department.
This Associated Bank Sports Update on 101.7 The Truth is powered by ESPN Milwaukee. I'm Julian Johnson. The Milwaukee Bucks are now 3-2 without Giannis as they lose to the Boston Celtics Wednesday night. They fly back home for redemption in a back-to-back game versus the Brooklyn Nets at Fiserv Forum. Coverage begins at 6 p.m. on our sister station, 620 WTMJ. Tip-off at 6:30. The number 2-seeded Marquette Golden Eagles face off against 15-seed Western Kentucky in the first round of the NCAA tournament. Coverage begins Friday at 12:30. With a 1 p.m. tip-off on 94.5 ESPN. And also in the South region, the number 5-seeded Wisconsin Badgers face off against the 12-seeded James Madison Dukes. Game starts Friday at 8:40. This sports update is presented by Associated Bank, proudly supporting our hometown teams, member FDIC.
It's the Tory Lowe Show on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Yeah. Count me out, gon' say whatever you want. Go, yeah. But you know we gotta keep the thing going. You know it. We be on the road. Everybody knows.
One-on-one, 7 The Truth, Tory Lowe Show, DJ Brother Z on the ones and twos. Yadaya Israel in the building.
That's right. Glad to be here.
Job Israel in the building.
Sir.
Israel United in Christ. They doing an event, a Stop the Violence Youth event at the Boys and Girls Club in Sherman Park tonight from 5 p.m. to 8. How can we keep up with y'all? Because I think y'all interested in the to see that y'all are able to be young, this young, willing to get out in the streets and try to put your hands on what's going on and make a real change and get some results. I like that.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You can find us on all platforms, literally all platforms. We're talking, we have our own website, www.israelunite.org. We're on Facebook, IUIC, Israel United in Christ. We're on Twitter. We're on Instagram. We're on TikTok. We're on Rumble. we're literally on all platforms. We have tens of thousands of videos across several different platforms. So literally you can go on YouTube, type in IUIC in whatever city of your choice, no matter where you are on the sound of this voice, and you can find people in your city doing the work, cleaning up the community. We go out in droves, men and women of the congregation. We clean up the city, pick up trash. We actually send food and non-perishables to our people who are struggling and who are less fortunate. We send them clothes. You can find us in whatever city you want, and we're trying to do our best to be an example, a walking Bible.
I need y'all to come to the community cleanup we doing on April 13th.
Hey,
all we need is
let's make it happen, Joe.
Hey, I need the brothers out there.
Yeah, let's make it happen.
Yeah. Well, Yadaya, Israel.
Yes, sir.
Sticks out to me when you talk about Israel United in Christ. What is that? What does that mean?
Right. So Isaiah 44. Everything goes back to the Bible. So names are important. And you know, we as a people, we have suffered a lot in this country, and we are coming out the other side with the Spirit of God. You know, it's a miracle that we can go through what we've gone through for hundreds of years as a people. And the Lord is sending his Spirit back in the earth, and we are standing up with a sound mind. And we are understanding that the only way forward is to equip ourselves with the Word of God.
And is Israel meaning that we are Israelites?
Yep, so watch this. Read Isaiah 44 and verse 5. Yes, sir. Let's read that first.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 44 and verse 5.
So let's read the prophecy about the last days. After we've gone through slavery, after we've lost our heritage, we've been given names of those who owned our forefathers. Those who, you know, because like let's say if your last name was Johnson. If you go back to your great-great-great-grandfather.
It's a slave name. Yes. Last name.
He came from the Johnson plantation. Yep. So I myself, it's time to shed that name as I walk in faith. Read that.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 44, verse 5. Mm-hmm. One shall say, I am the Lord's, and another shall call himself by the name of Jacob.
So this is going into a process of you learning who you are, being restored to your heritage that was taken from us. And then it says we would change our name. So it may start off as an alias. Like you say, you know, I'm going to start calling myself Jacob.
Right.
After the father of the Torah traps. I'm going to call myself Jacob, right? But then as time goes on, go ahead. Read the bottom.
One shall say, I'm the Lord's, and another shall call himself by the name of Jacob, and another shall subscribe with this hand unto the Lord, and surname himself by the name of Israel.
So it's prophesied that some of us would take the final step of faith and say, you know what, I'm going to change my name legally. I'm going to change my name. I'm not going to be a Johnson. I'm not going to be a Smith.
Change like
anymore.
Malcolm X.
Exactly. Exactly.
The belief that we have to drop that slave last name.
And go back to what we was prior to us going on those slave ships. Because we are the true descendants of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And our heritage is important. You
right.
know? And I know you got
the traditions.
Right. And this is not about and this is not a hate campaign or anything like
no,
that.
No, I mean just this loving, is just what you believe.
Right. And you loving self has nothing to do with animosity for anybody else.
Right.
But the lack of love for self is hurtful to your own people because your lack of self-love will reflect on the way you deal with your people, the way you deal with your wife, the way you deal with your community. Yep. So you must.
You got to redo yourself. You got to. And we always talk about self-worth. Like,
yes.
You got to dig deep and clean yourself out.
Yes.
And many times all of the ideas we were fed to us were given to us through colonialism.
Yes.
Or, you know, Western culture.
Yes.
And many times we have to unravel that to find out our true beliefs and ideas and really dig deep and research who we are because they never told us, they never showed us. You
exactly, because when you look at the our people say, oh, I'm doing it for the culture. They're making drill music.
That's pop culture.
My behind is brown. The women making music talking, you know, and they
sexy red.
I'm doing it for the culture, right? What is culture?
Don't you put that evil on me, Ricky Bobby.
So and they said that they're doing it for the culture. But what is this culture when you unpack it? imagine you take a person, you kidnap them, you bring them across,
right.
you bring them across the water, you chain them up into your basement. And in your basement is clothes and it's food and it's different kinds of food, different kinds of clothes. And then they start to, I'm only going to wear this kind of food. I'm only going to eat this kind of food. I'm only going to wear these kind of clothes. And they say, after years go by, and their children get exposed to these things, they say, oh, this is our culture. When it's really what was given to you.
Right.
You took the scraps that was given to you and then you've created that.
And made
miracles.
You
accepted it as a way of life.
Right.
You dressed it up to make it look real nice. You made it your own, but it's still the scraps that was given to you. And you're still in the land that's not yours against your will.
I agree.
So it's not our culture. Our culture is right here from Genesis to Revelations.
Right. Mm-hmm.
This is our culture, and it's rich. It's a rich culture. And once we return to it, we're gonna have a better eye. Because a lot of times we look
spiritual
at the Bible.
Eye.
Exactly, because we read the Bible from the outside looking in. But we're actually the people in the Bible. So once we realize that we're in it, we can see clearer as we look out into the world and be able to navigate amongst our own people and amongst everybody in society.
Mm. All right, look. Once again, give us some information how we can tap in with the event tonight.
Yes, sir.
Give us some information on how we can continue to get on schedule with what y'all doing for the community.
Yes, sir. So you can reach out to us at 855-484-4842, and then you can dial the extension based upon where you are, because we're all over the U.S. Mm-hmm. We're also in different parts of Central America, South America. We're in the continent of Africa. So call the number and dial in your prop extension. If you don't know the extension, just hold, stay on the line, and somebody will forward you based upon your location. Again, our website is www.israelunite.org. You can follow us on all social media platforms, IUIC, Israel United in Christ. You can follow our elder, Bishop Nathaniel. You can find him on Instagram under Nathaniel7.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of good information. He posts daily affirmations and daily understanding to help guide the people, because we know this walk is hard. And you got to deal with your own lusts and temptations. It's not easy. It's a daily fight.
Especially peer pressure going around the clock.
Exactly. So it's a daily fight. So he's right there in the fight with us, and he understands that. So follow him as well. And you can, like I said, we on YouTube, TikTok, Instagram, Rumble.
What about the event tonight?
Okay, so the event tonight at the Boys and Girls Club, it's at 3000 North Sherman Boulevard from 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. So come on out, free admission. And Lord's will, we pray that everybody leaves better than they came.
All right. I thank y'all for stopping through.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
It was
an honor.
Hey, look, Truth Nation, when we come back, we're going to open up the lines. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
The Tory Lowe Show returns after this on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, Gruber Law Offices and The Truth have raised the stakes for this year. The One Call, That's All Gruber Cash giveaway is now a 5K giveaway. Yes, you heard it right. $5,000 giveaway. Every weekday on 1017 The Truth, you will have the chance to be entered to win the 5K giveaway. Listen to The Truth for the One Call, That's All cue to call for your chance to win $5,000. Gruber Law Offices, One Call, That's All. Visit 1017thetruth.com. For official contest rules.
The Empowerment Small Business Loan Program, we're talking about up to $5 million, which for small business owners, we need that. That's like payroll, that's resources. So can you just let us know, what is the program and why is this lending program so important to Old National Bank?
Years ago, our CEO, Jim Ryan, this program is his brainchild. He was working with Roland Shelton, who
yes.
you know, Denise, out of Evansville. And they identified that African-American business owners, Hispanic business owners, Native American business owners, as well as women business owners, had a difficult time in obtaining financing from the traditional credit partners. And so we went out, created a program, launched it last year, 2023. And so far last year, we have helped over 100 successful minority and women-owned businesses with about $25 million in loans. We have already started this year with almost $8 million in approvals, again, geared toward minority business owners and women business owners that normally had difficulties in obtaining traditional credit finance.
How much does it cost to talk to Gruber Law Offices after a serious crash? It's free. Yes, free, as in it won't cost you anything to speak with us. Not sure if you have a case? Call our team at Gruber Law Offices today. Your first call and your first consultation are always free, and you'll never pay us a fee until we win your case. If you've been seriously injured, call Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
I am Detective Tiffany, and I am more than an officer. I come from a family of those who have served our country, and I continue that family tradition when I joined the Air Force Reserve. During my time there, I was encouraged to apply as a police officer, something I had never thought about doing before, but decided to give it a chance. The chance I turned into a fulfilling career in law enforcement. I am more than an officer, and you can be too. Come join the Milwaukee Police Department by applying. Go online and search Milwaukee Police Department Careers.
Introducing your trusted partner for all your freight transportation needs, it is Out the Mud Hauling. From local to long distance hauls, they ensure seamless, timely deliveries for businesses nationwide. They offer a variety of services like cross docking, order fulfillment, debris removal, hazardous material handling, pallet storage, and much more. Whether you're a seasoned shipper or an aspiring entrepreneur, trust Out the Mud Hauling for all your trucking needs across the USA. Contact them today at 262-278-1595. Out the Mud Hauling.
This is the Tory Lowe Show on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Sabbath morning, rise and shine, hit the block, make it hot, shake them down. We go at it till about 4 or 5 o'clock. Warfare, got my gear, I'm prepared for the op. And we talk it how we walk it, yeah, that's just how we rock. Friday night, gotta rest, in the morning, hit the block, shake them down. We go at it till about 4 or 5 o'clock. Warfare, got my gear, I'm prepared for the op. And we talk it how we walk it, yeah, that's just how we rock. Hey, I'm a
what it was, 7 the Truth, Tory Lowe, hey, Tory Lowe Show. Do this till the death of me. Is this Israel United in Christ Rappers?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That's
truth.
What I live.
It's it. Truth music.
That's right.
We used to call it gospel rap. I guess it's truth music now. Hey, when I was coming up, gospel gangsters and all that, Soldiers for Christ and mm-hmm. Truth for You and all that. So
right.
I was actually a gospel rapper when I was in church. I was a Winners in Christ.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was getting booed back then. Back then you got booed. Like right. The church wasn't ready for it now. Now they lit right now.
That's
I'm gonna have to send me to some of those links, DJ Brothers. I'm gonna have to, you know, this 2024, that's surprising. It is competitive.
That's right.
Powerful. I got a friend that is in the Nation, and he came on the show, and he does music. And mm-hmm. and what I'm saying is, it's just in us. That don't mean that we have to change anything. Art is art.
Right.
You know, so you don't have to change the art because you're looking at somebody else painting.
Mm-hmm.
You just paint what you see. And right. And a lot of people lose theyself mm-hmm. with trying to keep up with everybody else.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And so I always say that everybody was made as individually unique.
Mm-hmm.
And how you use that individualism is take your experiences and paint a picture from the way you see it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what makes your art, your work, the things that you do, it that's what separates you from everybody else.
Mm-hmm. And music is powerful.
Right.
Music is very powerful. Music can be used as a tool to destroy or to build.
Mm-hmm.
You know? So we got to be very mindful of what we put out there because it will return.
Right.
It's going to accomplish something. You know, like in the Bible with David and Saul. Saul envied David. He had an evil spirit on him. David would play and then Saul would be appeased of that evil spirit, and he would be calm, and he'd be back to his rightful self. So if the Bible is telling you that music can alter your mood and change your behaviors and your attitude, we got to be mindful of what we allow into our spirits because it's going to bring forth fruit.
Right. And to that point, I was watching a video actually about the club, and you wonder why these clubs are getting shut up. You in the club, you in the
tear the club up.
Yeah, you in the vicinity playing, shoot the club up, tear the club up. Then when three people get shot in the parking lot,
you dumbfounded.
Now we looking like what happened.
How did this happen?
Yeah, you had Earth, Wind, and Fire instruments playing, basses and sounds. You know, the vibes get the people going. Now you got drill, kill,
right.
Op.
You remember back in the early 2000s, that Knuck If You Buck came on,
yeah,
man.
And it's like,
you already knew. People stopped dancing. People tried to put their back against the wall, man.
Right.
Hey,
but got many people.
I ain't never scared by Bone Crusher.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And that's one of my friends, Bone Crusher. We got a song together. I never put it out.
Oh, yeah.
I ain't never put it out. But like I said, I mean, hey.
Yeah, but
that's what it was. And I think that people, we act surprised when we see outcomes, but we not checking the music we listening to. We not checking the culture that we participate in. And I always say it's programming. When you understand they call it we forget that they call it television programming.
Mm.
Or when you come to an event, they be like, here go the agenda for the program.
Mm.
They tell you. They tell you, like, this show is a program. It's right. A radio program.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we just community-based.
Right.
We just frontline-based.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so, like I said, we got to make sure that everything we take in, everything we consume, does it fit our plan for where we trying to go? And I always say, do your friends fit your plans and where you're trying to go to?
That's key.
I think a lot of people don't understand how powerful it is when you choose friendship or relationships with people,
yes.
that plays a huge factor in the outcomes.
Mm-hmm. They always say, show me your friends and I'll show you who you're going to be.
Mm.
You know, you hang around with 7 drug dealers, you'll be the 8th.
Right. It has to happen to that point.
Or you just be on drugs.
Right. about the music, you want to bring out that communications?
Yeah. Go ahead, get that. Yeah.
Going back to the scriptures, it's the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 33.
Come on.
It says, be not deceived.
Mm-hmm.
Evil communications corrupt good manners.
You see that? So God lets you know, because you might say, oh, it doesn't affect me. Oh, right. I can listen to drill music all day, 24/7. It's not going to affect the way I treat my brother. God said, do not be deceived.
Right.
Evil communication will corrupt good manners. It will corrupt your upbringing. It will corrupt your judgment. And then you wondering why you sitting in a cell like, what did I just do? You just you just killed your brother is what you did.
You know what I've been seeing?
Wow.
I see a lot of people that would come and just be so tough.
Mm.
But then when they go left and when they get legal,
when the
boys come get you.
Oh, yeah.
And then they go to court and they're crying and then you have a lot of resentment. Right.
Mm-hmm. 60 seconds. We seen it on First 48.
Right. All the time.
First 48, it shed light on the fact that once they got to deal with those consequences, that's when they revert back to their child.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
You know, and they want their mama, they want their daddy, you know.
Reality.
They tell it all for a pack of cigarettes.
And then the sad part about it is you never reached out to the family, but then when you go to jail, you want to run up the phone bill, mm-hmm. calling everybody collect, right?
Mm-hmm.
And this is where I say, like, we have to reorganize because now you want mama's love and nurturing on mm-hmm. a phone call that say you only got 2 minutes left. Right.
Mm-hmm.
And when she was telling you the whole time, like, don't, you know,
and
it'd be little nuggets. Every time a tragic event happens, I always know that there's a woman somewhere that was around them that was telling them not to do that.
Your Proverbs 19 verse 18.
It's always somebody that was in there. I'd be like, who was telling them not to do that?
Mm-hmm.
And they'd be like, I was the one. And, you know, mm-hmm. and I would always know that you will never go out here and get in any kind of trouble or chaos without somebody warning you
mm-hmm.
first. So it's always somebody in the family that probably saw something that they didn't like or tried to talk to you. Hey, look, maybe you shouldn't be doing this and that. And you ignored it.
Mm-hmm.
And then eventually
it caught up with you.
It caught up, right.
Mm-hmm.
The book of Proverbs chapter 19 and verse 18.
Because what you just said was very heavy. I want to back you up. Read that.
It says, chasten thy son.
Correct your son. Give them that upbringing that they need. Read.
While there is hope.
It says, while there is hope. Because sometimes people go people go beyond the point of return.
Mm.
And now you behind them, there's no more hope for you. You can repent behind those bars, but it's not much mama could do for you. You run that mama cell phone
that
bill
system.
when you could have changed your ways.
Right.
You know, I'm working out. You could have worked out here as a Planet Fitness for $10 a month.
Wow.
You don't have to go to jail to work out.
I still ain't been using my Planet Fitness.
I was going to say, Tori took that one.
I felt that one.
Or even find God. A lot of people wait till they get incarcerated to find God.
To get closer to God. You
could have did that as a free man.
Mm-hmm.
Hey. Look, I'm going to tell you this. This is another powerful. I want you guys to come back, you know, and other events and share, you know, because this is what it's about. And I always say to me, there's a lot of things going on out here where people believe a certain way or it's 101 genders and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
But I always say that the results is where you have to watch and mm-hmm. see where they're placing the energy and the outcomes of their energy. And that's action.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm more about an action than it is about words. So, you know, because you get people talking slick all the time, you
mm-hmm.
know, like I said, and when you talk about religious ideas, you got so many things out here that are harming people or, mm-hmm. you know, you got lawsuits against pastors and preachers and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
So the thing is, I always say, what is the fruit
mm-hmm.
of these people? Or what is the fruit of the leader to show that they are worthy to continue to have that attention.
Right.
Wow.
So mm-hmm. you have to look at what they're able to put out in the neighborhoods
mm-hmm.
to make the right judgment.
Right. Yeah, and that's one thing about Israel United in Christ. And again, the work speaks for itself, but mm-hmm. just me, just being a fan of my leadership, not only being a part of the movement itself, but also being an admirer, and I aspire to be like those men.
Right.
When I know where I came from,
right,
and I know I wouldn't be where I'm at today as a father, a husband, high up in my corporate position at my job, I wouldn't be where I'm at today if it was not for the tutelage of my elders. And all they do is point me to the Bible.
That's it.
And then when
and
I look,
give you that solid,
that solid counsel. Mm. And when I look at them, and I look at their wife, and I look at their children, I can see the fruit,
the examples.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I can see the humility in right. their children. I can see the shamefacedness in their wife, and the care and the nurturing spirit. So they are themselves walking Bibles, you know, which shows
examples.
Me they about what they shout. So now I have to learn integrity. Now I have to learn humility, because it's not just about being, because, you know, everybody got a podcast today. Everybody got a podcast, and it has become trendy. You know, positive messages have become trendy, but are they really applying it back at the ranch?
Hey. Right. Meanwhile.
Hey, look, let me tell you something. I can scroll right now and get 18 motivational speeches.
Yes.
Man.
You know.
give me 1 Samuel 2, because what he said is right on point. It's about action. So we out there in the communities, we're teaching our people line upon line. Hey, listen, let's stop whoring our sisters out. Let's stop making our women whores. Let's marry. If they're good enough to lay with, they're good enough to stay with.
Right.
All right? Let's start making better decisions. Let's stop being the first name mentioned when it comes to STDs. Let's be more responsible. Let's stop being known and classified as deadbeat dads. Let's stop being known as careless mothers. Let's start building ourselves up so we can be fruitful in society and take care of home. You know, read mm-hmm.
The book of 1 Samuel chapter 2 and verse 3.
Mm-hmm.
Talk no more so exceeding proudly.
Because everybody got a podcast there. Everybody got something to say. It says
God something
says,
powerful to say.
Yeah, God says talk no more so exceedingly proudly. Go ahead.
Let not arrogancy come out of your mouth.
Mm-hmm.
For the Lord is a God of knowledge,
mm-hmm.
and by him actions are weighed.
So we about that action.
Half.
We about that action. Our people need help. We here to
help.
1,000%.
Hey, look, we got to run a break. Tonight at the Boys and Girls Club of Greater Milwaukee, 3000 North Sherman Boulevard, there will be an event, the Youth of Violence, taking action against violence in the community.
That's right.
I appreciate y'all for coming through.
Man, thank you for having us.
Truth Nation, when we come back, we'll have more conversations. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe. Truth Nation, join the Truth Team on Saturday, April 13th for our third annual Tory Lowe Community Cleanup. We want you to go to truthcommunitycleanup.com to sign up and be a volunteer to help keep Milwaukee clean. Everyone who joins will get a free lunch provided by Cousin Subs. Register today at truthcommunitycleanup.com. That is truthcommunitycleanup.com to clean and beautify our city together. The Truth Community Cleanup is sponsored by Cousin Subs.
The pulse of the Milwaukee Bucks, straight from a Bucks legend.
Can't get it off. Marcus Johnson will, though. Can't leave him alone for a 12th.
Tap into Hear District with Marcus Johnson on Bucks Plus. Marcus and his son Chris offer a weekly beat on Bucks basketball. Get your questions answered and hear from the biggest names in basketball. Find Hear District with Marcus Johnson at Bucks.com/plus on the Bucks app or wherever you get your podcasts.
My name is Ariel. When I arrived in the U.S. at 19, I struggled to find job opportunities without my high school diploma. My entire life changed when I took a chance and got my high school diploma at age 22. Everything I have, my education, my career, my marriage, I owe to the Adult Literacy Center and my teachers. They were with me every step of the way, helping with my English and math, making sure I push through all the challenges.
Ariel, your success proves that what I'm doing as a teacher has real meaning.
It was an honor helping you achieve your greatness. Now you're helping others achieve theirs. It inspires me.
Education was the key that unlocked all my opportunities.
When you graduate, they graduate. Find free and supportive adult education centers near you at finishyourdiploma.org. Brought to you by Dollar General Literacy Foundation and the Ad Council.
Being blind doesn't always look how others may think. Stargardt disease was supposed to define me.
Retinitis pigmentosa aimed to overwhelm my family.
It tried to cut me down.
A blinding eye disease attempted to force me away from doing what I was born to do.
But it cannot stop me. I have the tools.
I will keep moving forward.
Pushing past the limits of this disability.
I know where to find support and where I can be seen.
Loss of sight won't blind our vision. Innovative research, educational resources, supportive community. The Foundation Fighting Blindness is leading the charge in finding treatments and cures for blinding diseases. Learn more at fightingblindness.org. A public service message from the Foundation Fighting Blindness.
Milwaukee's Black Talk lives here. You are listening to 1017 FM, 1510 AM WGKB Waukesha, and W269 DL Milwaukee, a locally owned Good Karma brand station. This is your 1017 The Truth News Update.
Hello, everyone. This is Rhea Riley with your news update. Demolition on the formerly known Northridge Mall began yesterday. The demolition was met with protesters advocating for proper pay as it began to break ground. According to the protester Mike Irvin, a local 139 member, the construction workers and heavy machinery operators were not being paid the proper wages for this project. According to Fox 6 Milwaukee, the demolition is funded using $15 million from the American Rescue Plan Act. The mall was purchased by the city. However, Mayor Johnson Cavalier states there are no certain plans for the property quite yet. The current goal is to have the entire property completely demolished by fall of 2025. Milwaukee police are asking for help to locate a missing 21-year-old woman named Brittany Thurmond. According to the police, Thurmond was last seen yesterday around 10:30 a.m. near Hampton and Sherman. It has also been alleged that she was with a man named Alfred Savoy. Savoy drives a 2021 black Honda Civic with temporary plates U727ZE. Thurman is around 5'6" and weighs 150 pounds with medium-length black hair. If you have any information, call MPD's 7th District at 414-935-7272. Two Milwaukee Department of Public Works employees have pled guilty to federal charges of embezzlement. The employees Kelly Whitmore Bailing and Kyle Kep were accused of embezzling more than $100,000 from the city and later used it to gamble at Pottawatomie Casino. The roles for the DPW were to maintain a fleet of city-owned vehicles and equipment. In 2022, they were able to accomplish this crime by selling the surplus of the property. According to the prosecutors, they sold the property they oversaw through DPW for less than the market value. The two have agreed to pay restitution to a total amount of $357,000. The DPW has yet to comment on whether they are still employed. This has been your news update. The Tory Lowe Show continues on the new 1017 The Truth.
We need each other.
That's facts.
I need my sisters. I need my brothers out here.
A coward dies a thousand deaths, and for all the bootlickers, may you die 1,001.
The place for the realest conversations.
Tory Lowe, want all the action? Or you want all the smoke? Oh, this
thing. I'm with all that smoke too, man.
I didn't see Ron Johnson. He trash. Chisholm is trash. How the hell are you here to help us? And your kids are dying in the street.
I understand that this is Milwaukee and everyone believe that if someone says something, it's snitching. It's not.
I don't care if it's the past. If you see the past or acting right, you check that fool. Where's the results?
Talking topics that need to be highlighted and discussed in our communities.
Would you trade places with a black person?
Sure, no, I would not.
Have you ever said the N-word?
I'm not.
Come on, be the truth. We on the truth.
Unfiltered and unfazed, this is the Tory Lowe Show on 1017 The Truth and The Truth app.
The reason I believe that racism is getting worse is because whites know that they will be outnumbered in about 20, 21 years. They're going to be outnumbered.
Hey, Tory, man, how are you doing, brother? I'm actually from India. We brown people can totally relate with you. Sometimes it's like, did that just happen to me?
We have to not let the government mind us either.
That cop ain't never been brought to the public because he ain't normal, and he may not even exist no more.
Say no more. Release the video.
You know, you keep on doing what you're doing, man. You're going to take over this talk radio, man. Just keep on focusing on what you're focusing on. I wish you a lot of love.
God bless you, brother.
Now, live from the American Family Insurance Studio in Milwaukee, here is Tory Lowe.
Justice Wisconsin, the truth, the most requested advocate in the state. 101.7 FM, the movement continues. Yeah, yeah. Yeah,
Milwaukee, stand up. It's Tory Lowe, the truth, from one to four. We about that action, so tap in and let's go. We want that justice, we want all the smoke. From Monday through Friday, trying to bring the city hope. Yeah, Tory Lowe, from one to four, Monday through Friday, let's go. We about that action from the block, and we ready, let's go. Tap in, and it ain't no holding back, we ready.
101.7 the truth. Tory Lowe, Tory Lowe Show, live from American Family Insurance Studio at the Avenue. The movement continues. The marathon continues right here on 101.7 The Truth. Thank you for joining me for the third hour of the Tory Lowe Show. And look, I'm going to need Truth Nation to chime into this because a judge rules illegal migrants have gun rights protected by the Second Amendment. Look. The judge says that the illegal migrants are protected by the Second Amendment. And when I saw this story, it just made me raise an eyebrow. I felt a little, the clip is from News Nation. Let's listen.
A judge in Illinois just ruled illegal immigrants have the right to keep and bear arms. Police arrested an illegal immigrant living in Chicago with a gun back in 2020. They charged him for violating the federal law banning illegal immigrants from having guns. Been on the books for a long time. Should I be shocked that an Obama appointee found a gun control law that she didn't like?
No. This whole push towards expanding the deference to the Second Amendment, in some ways, has kind of come full circle here, where something that really seems counterintuitive, the idea that someone who's not here legally still has that right, and you can't use this particular statute, which is commonly known as the felon in possession statute. But the way it's written, she really zeroed in on the language. And the gray area, of course, is whether or not his status, and frankly, I think the way he was using the gun calls a little bit into question, you know, how peaceful he is.
All right, so DJ Brother Z. Okay, so a felon, once you get the tag felon, you can't have a gun. But if you come over here illegally, you protected by the Constitution, you can have the gun by the Second Amendment. Somebody make this make sense. This judge is out of Illinois. And the thing is, we have been talking about how there has been an influx of illegal migrants in the country. And now this ruling out of Illinois says that now that these illegal migrants can have guns. Okay, well, didn't we see footage of police being beat up by migrants and then they let them go because, you know, they was letting them go and they was able to, like, move around through the country, like, and get these gift cards and things like that. And this is the Biden administration. This is the Obama administration that's doing this. And it's messy. It's messy. Because now, okay, how are they even registering? How are they getting past the background check to get the gun? And ain't the left talking about gun control and how we got to have these background checks and how we got to be more extensive and when we allowing people to get guns and things like that, and now we got people that are undocumented, at least in Illinois. But you know, when they rule somewhere, it spreads. This is interesting to me. this is interesting to me, and I can't. I think I'm more trying to look at a lot of the details of how this can affect our communities, because now, let's say something happens, they undocumented, you get shot. I don't know. DJ Brother Z. The case involved a Mexican man charged with a possession of a gun. The judge had made the ruling that he was protected under the Second Amendment. And now we're debating who has the constitutional rights. Is constitutional rights for us, like, you know, as American citizens? Us as people that are foundational Americans?
I was going to say, I don't know if immigrants have constitutional rights just because illegal, of them being immigrants.
That's what I'm saying. Illegal people that come over here, undocumented, they're saying that they have Second Amendment rights. And see how they move the goalposts? See how they move the goalposts when they wanted to work for them? This is why I say when we talk politically and people calling here with their chest puffed up, like, I wonder where the benefit coming from when they got a lot of air in their chest about it. Because every time we think we got a foothold on something, they just move the goalposts. And then think about the homeless people in America, the homeless problem we have in America, but yet we can shelter millions of illegal immigrants. All of a sudden, we got money for that. Can you imagine being a homeless person and can't get no resources in America, but then you see that American tax dollars is going to shelter people that have came over here undocumented? Can you imagine? Hey, look. It's getting deep. It's getting deep. And y'all sitting there watching it, too. Yeah, look. I'm talking about it because y'all ain't gonna say nothing about it. Y'all don't want to talk. Y'all don't want to talk about nothing. Y'all don't want to address nothing. Y'all don't want to. Y'all see stuff happening and y'all jump behind it. We got mass incarceration in our neighborhoods, and a person can get out and be righteous after they get out for years, and then they get caught with a gun or something, they could go to jail and get in trouble if you're a felon. I want to know. I want to know how y'all feel about this. I really want to know, especially the people that's on the left. I want to know how y'all feel about this because y'all the ones saying we need gun laws, gun control. Y'all the ones saying we need to have some type of something happening. And now it's people from the left saying that illegal migrants is protected under the Second Amendment. Undocumented. So what's that? Somebody explain to me, what is that? If you can explain it, let me know. 833-212-1017. Talk to text 833-212-1017. We're going to head to the lines. Mike, you on the new 1017 The Truth. Tap in.
Hey, Tory. You know what? You're hitting it right on the head. But, you know, the one thing you're missing is it's time to hold Glenn Moore accountable. The people that Milwaukee's voting for, they're part of the problem. How does she feel about migrants coming to the city?
Right. But we already know the left, the people on the left, this is their agenda. This is how it's happening. This is why it's able to happen.
And then you have...
that's why I want them to call in.
Then you have Sherwin Hughes, you know, running his mouth about Republicans left, you know, every day. Well, he votes Democrat, obviously.
Well, like I said, that's the Sherwin Hughes show. This is the Tory Lowe show, you know what I mean?
You do an awesome job, Tory. You had Hovde on, and I don't know why you wouldn't want to vote for him instead of, I don't even remember her name anymore.
Are you talking about Tammy Baldwin?
Tammy, yeah. What has she done for the state?
Well, like I said, that's why I want everybody to come through so they can explain. I'm an independent, so I like when everybody come through and actually explain what's going on. You know what I mean?
Hey, if you got good ideas, you got good ideas, but right. The left hasn't had a good idea in decades.
Yeah, but I think that they put us in a box on the information we receive. So I like anybody. This is an open door for people to come in and express their views, and so we don't have to hear the mainstream media. So I feel like we can talk to them. We can come up with our own conclusions from hearing the information, not be a bot or a sheep and be just told what to do. I think that it's time for us to start going into these rooms and asking the tough questions and understanding what's really going on instead of having our information shipped to us and packaged up.
Right on.
All right. All right. I appreciate you for tapping in, Mike. Winky. Winky, you're on the new 101.7 The Truth. Tap in.
Hey, good afternoon, sir.
How you doing, brother?
Listen, I'm blessed, man. Listen, we just had a town hall meeting last Saturday here with an open platform. And we'll have another town hall meeting, town hall fish fry, on the 26th of April. It's 18 to 34 and beyond. And we're going to open up the doors and open that platform back up. Listen, man, when you got people coming into this country, haven't been vetted, we don't know who ID they're actually using, and they come in this country, we got murderers, killers, and you take your citizens here and you make them lifetime felons.
Right.
Unable to own a gun, in some cases can't even own a crossbow. Listen, you can own a bow and arrow, but in some states a crossbow is illegal. And we're talking about giving rights. And if you remember me saying this, if these illegal immigrants ever get their hands on some guns,
right,
it's going to be a civil war. See, and the civil war is not going to be with the black man and the white man. I want y'all to understand that now. It's going to be with these particular people with this particular dialogue language that understand each other, okay? And they're going to rise up. And if they get guns, the little gangbanger in the hood, man, listen, I understand that we have, you know, that we're not afraid and we'll use and squeeze that thing. But these people don't have really any God fearing. See, we fear life after death. Some of these guys that's coming in this country don't believe in life after death. You know, they believe that once you're dead, you're just dead. So they have no problem with being killed or killing. See, we always worried about is we going to be right when we leave. These people don't care about being right when they leave because they understand that when they think when they die, they just die. So when these immigrants get their hands on these weapons, they're going to wreak havoc on this community. The 26th, the town hall meeting, the town hall fish fry, man, going to be at the 100 gyms on the 26th. And we opening up the doors to the public. We want to hear who's the best player for this town. Will it be Donald Trump with his mounting legal issues, or will it be Joe Biden with his failed policies that's really endangering us all? Can you imagine illegal immigrants getting guns and you got people, you just said it, been out of trouble for 30, 40 years, 50 years, can't have a gun in their house. Their wife got to have one in a safe with a fingerprint if it's a gun in the house. You can't even be around one in your own store. You can't even protect your own goods. We got illegal Arabs running around here with pistols on their hips, man, right now in the stores. And the Arabs got their hands in the gun trade. The Arabs and the opioids. We just looking at the Mexicans. Them people, man, is invested in this community. And I ain't just looking at the old Mexicans, because the Arabs is like sneaky snakes, boy. They coming. But I'm going to tell y'all something. You be at that doggone town hall meeting, because we want to know from you who the best player for this town going to be. See you, brother.
Hey, look, I'm telling you, it's something that we got to talk about. Judge rules illegal migrants can carry guns. Brr, brr. Hey, that, to me, I got to raise an eyebrow on that. But when we come back, we got Sandra, we got Al. We're going to see what they got to say. We got some talk to text. We got some people in the chat chiming in. We're going to try to get to it all when we get back. Truth Nation. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
Don't touch that dial. The Tory Lowe Show will be right back on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app,
and 1017thetruth.com.
The baseball season is finally here, and we want to celebrate the Milwaukee Brewers with you, Truth Nation. We are excited to announce our Take Me Out to the Ball Game giveaway. From now through the end of April, we will be giving away tickets to cheer on the Brewers live from American Family Field. For your chance to win a pair of tickets to a game, you must download the 1017 The Truth app and be on the lookout for our weekly Brewers Push notification. Play ball with The Truth and go watch The Brew Crew by downloading the 1017 The Truth app today. For contest rules, visit 1017thetruth.com.
The Empowerment Small Business Loan Program, we're talking about up to $5 million, which for small business owners, we need that. That's like payroll, that's resources. So can you just let us know, what is the program and why is this lending program so important to Old National Bank?
Years ago, our CEO, Jim Ryan, this program is his brainchild. He was working with Roland Shelton, who you know, Denise, out of Evansville. And they identified that African-American business owners, Hispanic business owners, Native American business owners, as well as women business owners, had a difficult time in obtaining financing from the traditional credit partners. And so we went out, created a program, launched it last year, 2023. And so far last year, we have helped over 100 successful minority and women-owned businesses with about $25 million in loans. We have already started this year with almost $8 million in approvals, again, geared toward minority business owners and women business owners that normally had difficulties in obtaining traditional credit finance.
Protect your dream home with American Family Insurance. And you can weather any storm. You'll also save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote. Find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit amfam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Increase in taxes while families are paying more for everything from gas to groceries is wrong. Milwaukee voters should oppose increase in property taxes by nearly 30% in order to provide increased funding yet again to Milwaukee Public Schools. They've already wasted nearly $1 billion in new taxpayer funding, and now they want more? They don't even have a plan on how they'll spend it. Enough is enough. Milwaukee voters should just say no.
Paid for by Enough is Enough. Vote no.
What's up, Milwaukee? I'm here, Tanasi Antetokounmpo, my first live ever analysis with some guy. I don't know if you see his name.
Giannis on the alley-oop.
You can get your tickets at talifeshow.com. Can't wait for you guys to see Friday night with Giannis, all ages. You know what? Just be there.
The Analysis, live at Potawatomi Casino Hotel on March 22nd. Presented by Curbless Ready to Drink Cocktails. Get your tickets now at talifeshow.com.
It's the Tory Lowe Show on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, get your tickets now to see NBA MVP Giannis Antetokounmpo join his brother Thanasis live on stage for a sit-down conversation talking about their journey from Greece to living their NBA dreams. They will also discuss trending topics and the life of an NBA superstar. This event is Friday at Potawatomi Casino and Hotel starting at 6 p.m. Visit talifeshow.com to get your tickets. Again, that's talifeshow.com to get your tickets now. Watch the Analysis podcast live as Giannis will join his brother, Thanasis, for an interview. All ages are welcome, so bring your whole family. The Analysis Live is presented by Carbless. Can't wait to see you there this Friday night. Again, visit talifeshow.com to get your tickets today. The award-winning 1017 The Truth proudly celebrates Women's History Month. Tune in all March as we celebrate the remarkable achievements of women throughout history. Follow The Truth on Facebook, Instagram, as our very own Carrie Noni will interview history makers and share inspiring stories of the excellence of Black women. 1017 The Truth celebration of Women's History Month is sponsored by the Milwaukee Police Department. Hey, look, I'd like to thank everybody for chiming into the show today. Another powerful show. We've been talking about this ruling now from an Illinois judge that rules illegal migrants can carry guns. And this stemmed from a situation where a Mexican man was charged with possession of a gun. I guess he shot into a vehicle or something, and then they took him to jail and things like that, and they took it to court. And now I guess they're saying that he's protected under the Second Amendment. Hey, I want to know. 833-212-1017. Talk to text 833-212-1017. If you're a felon, if you have in possession of a gun, it's a wrap. And then they're gonna count the bullets. You know how they do on the movies where they catch the felon with the gun, and then this how much time you get for this bullet. This how much time you get. They use that against the felons, and they living out here in the neighborhoods where the police coming with the guns, and they saying that you can't protect your family even if you had so many years of just clean living. 833-212-1017. Sandra, you on the new 1017 The Truth, tap in.
Hi, Tory.
How you doing, Sandra?
I'm fine. How are you doing?
Hey, look, I'm trying to figure out what's going on with the Second Amendment.
Well, you know, I always call and speak about it. The thing is, we got two groups. We got the Republicans and the Democrats.
Mm-hmm.
One side will say we want to do something about it, and the other side says our Second Amendment to have them.
Mm.
In other words, thoughts and prayers. That's all I hear. So ain't nothing going to be done. Thoughts and prayers. We'll just keep saying we're going to keep praying and we're going to keep thinking.
Right.
Nothing's going to be done because it's obvious. You don't even hear that no more. Now it's mental.
Oh,
everybody's
wow.
mental now.
Right.
So that's what you know, you hear it. Yeah, everybody's mental.
I talk about it.
Yeah, to tell you the truth, the reason you see a lot of mental instability is because, number one, your prison people. I got a son in prison.
Mm-hmm.
My son good in prison because they put him on mental meds. They sent him up there to, not to Oshkosh, Winnebago. It's a mental hospital up there. They sent him up there and put him on mental meds, so they crazy as all get up. And I have a relative that worked down at the jailhouse, and they would tell me how bad and mental these people are. But it goes back to Reagan. Reagan cut the money to all this stuff. He started it. Now, I might have started before he did, but I remember good, and they started putting mental people out of, you know, the hospitals and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
So now they have cut the funding, and now they're trying to ease a little bit of it back. We just have so much gun shootings. So they're trying to ease it back. So now they're mental. Now thoughts and prayers are thrown away. And I do vote Democratic. I'm not ashamed to admit it. I mm-hmm. do. And now I have to start researching and reading a lot about what's really going on, because you got these two parties and they got to bargain with one another in
right.
order to get something.
Oh, it's
changed.
WWE.
Yeah. And this one's saying, no, we don't want that. And the other one said, yeah. So you got to have a bargain there. So the bargain ain't going to be for us, because usually who's kind of missing in all the good things that's really supposed to be good in life are the black people. So these we are. I mean, I'm seeing. I live here. I've worked here. I grew up here. I went to school here. I worked there. I retired from Allen Bradley. They had a lot of, you know, Spanish people and other people working in there, and they do cheap labor. They do stuff they say we won't do.
Well, I'll say this. Well, I'll say this, Sandra. They're flooding our neighborhoods with the illegal migrants because we are the sanctuary city ideas. Okay, so they own in our neighborhoods, and then if they can get hold of guns, it just seems like a bomb in the making. And they got a lot of our brothers tied down because they committed a felony, and some as young as 17, 18, 19 had no mercy on them. Felony. First time up, felony. But here come the illegal migrants, and they protected by the Second Amendment in here. Wasn't even born on American soil. I'm just throwing it out there, because if you could look and see where this could be going, and who could be mostly affected by some of these decisions, you understand what I'm saying. 0068 says, illegal migrants can own a gun, wow, but a felon who's done their time can't have one to protect themselves or their families. I think you're all missing the point. Which group has the most felonies attached to them? Black men. So who is really an affront to? Black men, this is a message to us, not Democrats or Republicans. But it was a liberal judge who did it. How's it, you know, first of all, they trying to ban automatic weapons and guns and trying to get gun rights together. But, oh, now this is going on. Al, you're on the new 101.7 The Truth. Tap in.
Well, first thing I want to say is everybody is not trying to get close to God nor repent. And it also said in the Bible that y'all choose to follow that has 30,000 changes, that if you are a Christian and you have a weapon to cause death, that is very non-Christian. So for you Christians, you shouldn't care if illegal have a gun. Mm. Now if a person here in the United States is a felon and they have a gun and they got a felony and it was due to a non-domestic violence, then their charges should be dropped. Mm. But this all comes from people not compromising. And I don't have a problem with migrants in my neighborhood because I have yet to have to pick up a pamper, a half pint bottle, and a box of chicken bones.
Mm-hmm.
But I will say this, when it comes to these people who say they're close to God, some of y'all people who claim you Christian, y'all are the most evilest, devilest people that's here in the United States. Majority of child rape starts in the church. So again, if you are a Christian,
300,000 lawsuits against the Catholic Church.
And if you are a Christian, you don't supposed to own a gun anyway. So that would make you a hypocrite. So why are you worried about a migrant having a gun? But on the other hand, let's not take this opportunity to use fear, because it's only two things black people fear: migrants and the white man. But y'all don't fear each other because y'all don't mind shooting each other. But y'all won't argue that. And that's in the Bible, too. And this is the same God who let black people suffer at the beginning, during, and at the end of slavery. And he had the power to kick everybody out of heaven. And on top of that, he looked just like me and you. So I don't know if that's the God you want to follow.
Mm.
And one more thing, it said in the Bible, Jesus was always kicking it with prostitutes and tax collectors. So is that a person you want to follow? Birds of a feather flock together.
Hey, all right, Al. Hey, look, I'm going to tell you right now, when we, you know, when we discuss these things, and you, that's why I get to all these different perspectives, so you can listen and see what people understand to be the truth as themselves. But at the end of the day, when you see what's going on and you see politically what's going on and when you see what's going on with our neighborhoods, I just be wondering how some people feel like they got some type of steam or leverage when they call politically. I want to know where the leverage is. I'm interested. I'm interested, DJ Brother Z. I be asking. Hey, look, but when we come back, we'll be joined on the lines by Justice Wisconsin Advocate and author Elizabeth Brown. Truth Nation. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
More of the Tory Lowe Show is next on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Associated Bank knows your small business isn't just a venture. It's your dream and a vital part of the community. And we're not just a bank. We're your neighbors. We're looking out for you. That's why Associated Bank offers quick online applications and approvals with funding in as fast as one business day, checking with no minimum balances or maintenance fees, and prompt customer service. Explore our products at associatedbank.com/business or visit a branch for more details. Subject to credit approval. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Sharon needed legal help. She needed Gruber Law Offices.
When I think about Gruber Law Office, I think about how they took care of me, how they make sure that you get what you're supposed to get. Gruber Law Office. One call, that's all. I will always, always trust One Call, that's all.
Injured? Call Gruber Law Offices today. One call, that's all.
They are the best. I'm very happy.
The award-winning 101.7 The Truth proudly celebrates Women's History Month. Listen to one of our incredible Truth teammates highlight the remarkable achievements of Black women throughout history.
To celebrate this year's Women's History Month, I'd like to take time to honor Judge Constance Baker Motley. When I think of Judge Motley, I think of one word: pioneer. She was a trailblazing American civil rights activist, lawyer, and jurist. Breaking barriers throughout her illustrious career, she played a pivotal role in the legal battles that reshaped the landscape of racial equality in the United States. Born on September 14, 1921 in New Haven, Connecticut, she faced racial discrimination but excelled academically. In 1943, she became the first Black woman to graduate from Columbia Law School, setting the stage for her groundbreaking legal career. Freshly out of law school, Motley worked as a law clerk for Thurgood Marshall within the NAACP's Legal Defense and Educational Fund. She quickly gained recognition for her skills in the courtroom, playing a crucial role in desegregation cases, including the landmark Brown v. Board of Education in 1954. Motley's brilliance continued to shine through as she broke new ground as the first Black woman elected to the New York State Senate in 1964. And a year later, she broke another barrier as President Lyndon B. Johnson appointed her as the first Black female federal judge in the country. Judge Motley's impact and legacy can still be felt today, even outside of the courtroom. She's inspired generations to continue to fight for justice and equality. Thank you, Judge Motley, for being a phenomenal woman and a pioneer.
Tune in to The Truth as we celebrate the greatness of Black women all month long. The celebration of women's history on The Truth is sponsored by the Milwaukee Police Department.
It's your boy, Tory Lowe, from The Tory Lowe Show. Tap in for that action. Listen to The Truth all day, every day by downloading The Truth app or stream on Spotify, TuneIn, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, or Stitcher. Milwaukee Black Talk, 101.7 The Truth.
This is the Bloomberg Black Business Beat, sponsored by ProgressiveCommercial.com, where you can get a business insurance quote in as little as 6 minutes. Investors are nervous about the future of big media companies. Recently, Paramount has seen its shares sink as rumors float around about a potential sale or takeover. John Rogers is co-founder of the first Black-owned mutual fund company in the United States, Ariel Investments. He says despite all the bad news lately, he's optimistic about groups like Paramount.
Content is king. So if you're Paramount Global and you own the rights to CSI and The Godfather and Mission Impossible, and you've got the NFL and the Super Bowl and the Grammys and all these extraordinary brands that are there, all the active, you know, 60 Minutes and CBS Sunday Morning and all the different things that you can watch, we think that content will be valuable however you end up getting it.
Rogers also says he's been buying Paramount shares. I'm Bloomberg's Justin Milliner on the Black Business Beat.
You are listening to The Tory Lowe Show on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, join the Truth team Saturday, April 13th for our third annual Tory Lowe Cleanup. I want you to go to truthcommunitycleanup.com to sign up and be a volunteer to help keep Milwaukee clean. Everyone who joins gets a free lunch provided by Cousin Subs. Register today at truthcommunitycleanup.com. That's truthcommunitycleanup.com. Let's work and clean and beautify our city together. The Truth Community Cleanup is sponsored by Cousin Subs. Hey, joining me on the lines is Justice Wisconsin Advocate and Author Elizabeth Brown. How you doing, Queen?
Hey, happy Thursday, King.
Happy Thursday. Hey, look, when I seen this, I was like, the felons can't have the guns. Because it's illegal for them to hold the guns. But the illegal migrants is protected by the Second Amendment and carrying guns.
Come on.
And they flooding
I'm
them
not surprised.
In our neighborhood. See, this is the thing. They putting them in these sanctuary cities, which largely is Democratic. We got the brothers and
Correct.
Sisters in Chicago trying to tell everybody that they tried to shut them out the common council meeting. Because they was trying to speak out and
Correct.
Get their views heard, and they had taken up resources that were that they couldn't even get to use for the children and the people in their communities. And then you got the people in New York trying to tell everybody what's going on, and they're flooding. So these are largely Black townships that are being flooded with these illegal migrants, but now they're saying it's okay for them to grab the pistol. But we're massively incarcerated.
And you're correct.
We're massively incarcerated. Yes. And if you're a felon, even if you've been out for years, you can't get a gun to protect your family.
You sure can't. And again, when we talk about the cities that they hit, these are major cities when it comes to voting, especially for the black bloc. You know what I'm saying?
This the black voting bloc.
This is war. You understand? And what the sad reality of the judge that passed that, of course, she was appointed by Barack Obama, okay, who found that it was legal for an illegal immigrant who broke the law to get here. He's protected by the law that he broke to get here. You know what I'm saying? Like, I mean, when you think about this, like I said, you know, the foolery of home of the free and land of the brave. We lead in the most incarcerated in the world. Where's the freedom in that? You know what I'm saying? Where is the bravery when you have illegal immigrants that's able to break the law to come here, when we had homeless individuals being locked up because they was homeless?
Right. And they trying to stop homeless people from
being fed
in some places.
Sorry, they was being evicted. They were being evicted off the street.
Right.
They were being homeless Americans was being evicted. Not only that, you kick out veterans out of a nursing home to allow these illegal immigrants to come here who broke the law. You're housing them. You're clothing them. Now you're telling me that they have a right to bear arms under the same law that you hold us near and dear to. You understand? And you're telling me that this illegal immigrant who shot into some cars during the civil unrest,
right,
that he has more rights than a black man do.
Sorry.
They told us this day was coming. And it's here. It's alive and it's well. But what they not telling us, because they shouldn't have to tell us nothing. It's being shown.
It's right in front of your face. This is why I say, are we really paying attention to what's happening? Or are we just sitting back watching TV and scrolling on social media? I'm just trying to figure out why it's hard to make the connection on what's going on outside the window. That's why I say, open up the window.
This is a war. Hey, there is another, when we was talking about Tyson's Foods and how they fired all the Americans, and now here come a report that Tyson's Foods is about to group up with some type of bug something, you know what I'm saying? And this is why they're getting rid of the Americans, because they know the Americans not going to go with the status quo of being poisoned. And these people coming over here right now wouldn't give a damn what they was putting in the food. You know what I'm saying? As same as these illegal immigrants becoming police officers. They're not
which is something that they're trying to do in Illinois right now. And they said that if they were able to obtain a gun, they could be servicemen.
Sorry, but what they didn't tell you 8 years ago, if you go back, all you have to do is Google it. Where it's always been a loophole for legal and illegal immigrants to obtain a fire weapon. You know what I'm saying? By getting a hunting license. You know what I'm saying? And they able to get weapons that way. It was a student in Arizona some years ago. I think it was like 8 years ago or something, who bought two AR-15s. He was a college student and kept it on the college campus, but it was a loophole then by getting a hunting license again. You're not legal, but in the same totality, illegal immigrants been getting counted on the census. So this is a game.
Right.
It's really a game. You know what I'm saying? Any way that they can tax somebody, but American citizens, black, white, Asian, or other, needs to be worried. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you not, you should be.
And the thing
is, this is real.
And the thing is, first of all, all of these Democratic townships, Milwaukee is close to as it could come to actually being a sanctuary city, because when the conversation came up in Milwaukee, they was like, nope, we ain't going to do nothing two illegal immigrants. We're gonna, we're not gonna ship them back. And then you got the townships who are sanctuary cities, like Chicago, like New York, mm-hmm. and things like that. And now they sought this up, so now they're placing these people in these townships that are largely liberal, that are largely black communities. And now the brothers and sisters in these townships and these people that voted Democrat, that voted for all of these things, and now they're saying, hey, they raising an eyebrow and they are being shut out of common council meetings to express themselves. And this is grandma, auntie, you know, lifetime liberals that they're doing this to.
Yeah, of course. But not only that, Tory, when we talk about, you know, they're talking about how racist it was for us to have an ID. In Chicago, they was telling the citizens when they was trying to lock them out that they would need an ID to even being able to get in these meetings while illegal immigrants
trying to lock them out the meeting
through the door.
What'd he say? But no more money for you.
Right, but illegal immigrants who has no identification, because they was leaving their stuff at the border, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Coming over here with no identification, you're going to tell the citizens who pay your taxes that they got to show an ID. But these are the same Democrats who said it was racist.
And
that you needed an ID to vote.
And they flying them in the plane. They flying the migrants in with a plane. The government flying them in.
Paid. Hey, luxury. But again, like I said, Democrat, Republican, tomato, tomato.
Right.
Because the same Republicans who was pushing for these gun laws, now these illegals got a right, thanks to what it is, the legislation that they've done.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And this so-called Constitution, who the Constitution is going to uphold illegal immigrants, because everybody that's here, that's standing on the neck of black folks, was an illegal immigrant first, okay?
And also,
these are immigrants who stole our land, who are portraying themselves like they're better than somebody else. But America, these laws is built for immigrants.
Hold on, listen.
This is why.
All I'm saying is the Republicans doing something too. Governor Ron DeSantis signed a legislation prohibiting legal local municipalities from allowing people to camp or sleep on public property. The homeless people.
Come on.
Passing laws against the homeless.
More regulation.
That they would ensure homeless individuals have the resources they need to get back on their feet. But they're saying that the homeless people can't even camp out or sleep on public property no more down in Florida.
Story in New York, they got the illegal immigrants selling food, clothes on the sidewalk.
Well, we need a permit.
When you got a food truck, they telling you where you can and can't be, and you got to pay to have that. Okay? The health department got to come in and do all of these things, and now these illegal immigrants is having their way. It's a free fall for them.
Mm.
We're the one being held to a higher standard. And they broke the law to get here, and you and I upheld these so-called laws that they get to come in and break and get rewarded $9,000 a month. They're buying houses. They're buying cars while we're losing houses.
Buying guns.
Losing cars. Sorry.
Wow.
Hey.
Hey.
Wake up.
Hey, look, when we come back, Elizabeth Brown, I want to get your final thoughts. Truth Nation. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
The Tory Lowe Show returns after this on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Milwaukee, we are in the heart of the basketball season, and we have all the local hoops news you need to hear. Get your weekly smile on with our Nothing But The Truth basketball report, brought to you by Bubon Orthodontics. On Nothing But The Truth, we'll keep you in the loop on all the local Milwaukee hoops news, from high school all the way to the pros. So don't miss your shot to join in on the hoops talk by tuning into the Truth Basketball Report on Nothing But The Truth, right here on the new award-winning 1017 The Truth, brought to you by Bubon Orthodontics, the official smile of the Milwaukee Bucks.
Heard at work? If you or someone you know has been injured on the job, they may be eligible for workers' compensation benefits, including lost wages, coverage of medical bills, job retraining, and even a lump sum cash settlement. I'm attorney Alex Eichhorn, partner and workers' compensation attorney at Tabak Law. The workers' compensation system can be complicated and frustrating to navigate. At Tabak Law, we have helped hundreds of injured workers. Contact Tabak Law to set up an absolutely risk-free consultation at TabakAttorneys.com. Contact Tabak for the payback. TabakAttorneys.com.
Life's better with American Family Insurance because our home policies help protect your dreams and come with peace of mind. Save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
It's early in the year, and we're trying to hit these fitness goals. Zero to 100 Fitness is dedicated to the Milwaukee community, offering affordable and quality fitness and mixed martial arts programs for the last 10 years. They have competitive and novice classes in MMA, kickboxing, and grappling for all skill levels and ages. From youth, community outreach, women's self-defense, and personal safety programs, Zero to 100 Fitness will help you on your journey to greatness. So get up off the couch and into the best shape of your life. Call 414-522-1275 today.
Severe flooding from recent hurricanes and other storms has left hundreds of thousands of cars, trucks, and other vehicles unsafe to drive. Flooded vehicles are supposed to be dismantled for usable parts or crushed for scrap, and a flood title should be issued to that car. But some shady dealers will buy a flooded vehicle, clean it up, and get it retitled with no indication it was flooded. Or uninsured cars will be cleaned up by the owner and sold online, also with no warning to the buyer. If the price is too good to be true, it probably is. Make sure to check for flood damage and have a qualified mechanic inspect the vehicle before you write a check. The free VinCheck service from the National Insurance Crime Bureau is a good place to start. Head over to NICB.org to check it out.
To report fraud, call us at 1-800-TELL-NICB. This is a public service message from the National Insurance Crime Bureau.
More of the Tory Lowe Show is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
So let it rip.
Tune into the award-winning 101.7 The Truth this Saturday at 10 a.m. for the debut of Community Heartbeat, presented by Outreach Community Health Centers. Sharon Hughes will speak with practitioners and health experts about living a healthier lifestyle, how to focus on preventative health, the importance of health screenings, and much more. This is not just a show. This is a movement dedicated to bringing our community together through wellness. Do not miss Community Heartbeat, presented by Outreach Community Health Centers, this Saturday at 10 a.m. on 101.7 The Truth, Milwaukee Black Talk. Elizabeth Brown, hey, let me get your final thoughts on the show today.
Again, very impactful. Every day is something different. My quick take on the... Charles, your lunch is ready, your dinner's ready. Or
Charles! Hey! Oh, you want to answer the question or what?
Please.
The question was, can a trans woman who's dating a man tell a woman, give advice to a woman on how to keep a man?
Hell no! He can't even give advice to himself on how to be a man, because his whole life he been trying to be me. In reality, when we talking about Miss Netta, he's so worried about Charles cheating with a woman because Charles always in women's business. You know what I'm saying? Hey. So again, how
got
can
the BBL.
A man who ain't never really accepted himself as a man tell me what I need to do to keep a man that he worried about cheating with a woman? I mean, make it make sense. Again, any man, okay, transgender or other, can't tell no woman nothing about being a woman and what she needs to do to keep a man, because nine times out of ten, like I said, Charles wants to be, I mean, because Charles loves women, okay? He always in the, and he always in the woman's comments and telling women what they need to do. And look here, fam, mental illness is real, but black women, just women in totality, quit playing. How he gonna give you some tips and you the original? It makes no sense. Mental illness is real. Y'all need to sit down and figure out who you is. Find the confidence within yourself. Because in reality, this is a man who's been trying to be you. He can't compete where he don't compare, but if you weak, he's in competition with you the whole time. If your man left you for him, he was gay the whole time. That ain't got nothing to do with a woman. Like, he just like the tools that you unable to give him. You saying? In reality, no. France, men, stay in y'all lane.
Hey.
Black women, just heterosexual women, period. Get y'all life. It's time for y'all to get some confidence, because this is out of hand. It's out of hand.
Hey, look, I'm wondering when my lunch going to be ready.
Hey, look here, Tory, you gonna starve, fam, cause unless you want to play the game.
Hey, look.
Hey, talk. Hey, Miss Netta said she'll give you some lunch.
Nah, man.
Hey,
I don't want nothing on that plate. But I appreciate you for being on the front lines as usual, and we got a lot of work to do, Queen.
Hey, we working, King. One love.
All right, talk to you soon. All right, DJ Brother Z.
All right, Tory Lowe from 104. Let's get it.
All right, Truth Nation. Look, I appreciate y'all for tapping in. There's an event tonight, a Youth Stop the Violence event at the Boys and Girls Club at Sherman Park at 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. Stop through. And look, y'all be safe. And I'll talk to you tomorrow. Dr. Ken Harris up next.
Milwaukee's favorite station.
Please, please, Lisa, please, for the love of Jehovah, don't kick me or anybody with a prosthetic leg. Please. Why do I even gotta say please? Because what if you kick me and it falls off? I ain't gonna pick it up. You try to kick me. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna hit you with your own leg. I teach you a lesson.
Coming with Straight Truth.
And you know what? If you want to make it about race, I need you to hold your black men accountable. Don't let these black men get away with anything. Because what does that say about you? Because if you're going to be that person who's not going to hold your own people accountable, we have nothing.